Welcome to the Bob and Tam Show, right here in Ormond Beach at Bruce Russmeyer's. No, it's not Bruce Russmeyer's anymore. It's Teddy Morris, Harley Davidson, pertaining to the nation.
Hello.
Ain't nobody on yet. No.
Hi, it says.
Oh, yeah, five people. Hi. So we're here at the dealership. You can see behind us bikes, bikes, and more bikes, and people. And we just got done watching, what do they call that thing? I forget what
the
they call
civilian
it.
Civilian rodeo.
Yeah, that was going on out front. We kind of got to the end of it. Today's been very, very hectic day. All the people here wrote you back.
All right. There's John Burke. The thing is, going to Myrtle Beach this year? Yes, we'll be there.
Yes. That's paid for, so we should be there.
I'm just saying if the trailer makes it. Hey, Ramblin' Rome's on. Thank you for verifying.
Trying to check out our visible phone. They're supposed to have a new updated thing that they want us to do, and I'm not quite sure. So what I want to know is, we have the $40 plan now, and they sent a thing saying I need to update, and you might send me a new chip, and am I going to get any better service, data service, out of the 45 versus the 30? That's what we're going to talk about. Slim Jim's on. Hey, Slim Jim. John Burke, cool to see you there. Yep. We got a bunch of great stuff to tell you. If you are an Indian, you ride an Indian bike, and you love your Indian, you know who you get a chance to meet? The president of Indian is coming to Daytona. Can you believe that?
He's going to lead off the ride.
For the Indian owners. Yep. So I think it's a Tuesday.
And all the papers.
No, it's the same day we're doing something else.
Saturday.
It must be Saturday ride. So we're going to try to get there at 8 to see if we can get, he's doing a meet and greet, and then he's going to lead the ride, or he's going to wave the people out. I don't know what he's going to do.
I think he's going to lead the ride. Yeah, it's not going to escort him out. He's going to
salute him.
I guess. I don't know. Something like that.
I don't think he's
But
right.
He's going to do a meet and greet, supposedly. And
I mean, really.
Stuff.
So we're going to get him on camera if he shows up. It came from corporate, so he should be there. He's never even been to Sturgis that I know of. So it's kind of special coming all the way here to Daytona for this. So we found that out today. So some breaking news. And we'll have a video coming up soon. On Monday, I think I'm going to put them all in. I'll put Indian with all my other great stuff. So Monday's video is going to be really good. If you're thinking about coming to Daytona or you just want to know what the heck is going on. We went to a whole bunch of places, which is not all of them yet. Made it to
Willie's.
Willie's. Whoops. Better hold the camera.
And you didn't get your Allen wrench,
no.
Huh?
No.
Probably got one here.
Probably have to go in the parts. You have to go in the service department probably to get it. So, not high enough. Oh, a little higher. A little higher. Turn it this way.
So we were paying 35, and now he wants to go to 40.
We pay 40 now, and they have two plans: a 30 and a $45 one. Okay, is the wall of death set up at the pavilion? No. Really, there isn't a whole much of nothing here yet. It, you know, they've got the guy does pinstriping. Roach, he's got his stuff out here. The guy that we don't recommend does the ram mounts, he just is here. I've seen his trailer down here. Who else is here? You know, there really isn't anybody, not much being set up yet. Most of the people, I think, are going to be coming in tomorrow and Monday. So we'll let you know. Did anybody ever respond to you and say if they were going to be here?
Who?
The Wall of Death.
Oh, no.
Should ask Shelly. We didn't think
about
it. What do we got here? So we'll check it out. But right now it is not. What?
DX Doogie.
No, this guy here?
No, the one you just clicked on.
DX Dougie. Hi from Scotland.
All right.
And Red Finger Ron's on.
How's the motorhome going?
Neil's on. That's interesting. Is he going to stake a claim if HMD folds? Don't know. Is the Indian guy trying to stake his own yard? He said it twice. Not that I know of. I don't even know why he's coming. Who knows? It's kind of neat. You know, we're not Indian.
The marketing guy says that's what the literature said that came from
Indian
corporate. So he says, I haven't heard nothing about it. It says it on the flyer. Corporate sent it. So I'm just saying he's coming. Maybe he'll show up. Maybe
so we'll
he won't.
Out.
But it looks
so,
like he should.
Ron, I don't know if you know that out at Jacksonville, Adamac is having stunt shows. They have some professional stunt riders out there today and tomorrow. We're going out tomorrow. We're going to be out there at noon, get the first show. And so might be something you might want to think. What else are we doing tomorrow? We're going to do a live while we're out there, and then we'll come back.
And we have to be at somebody's house by 6:30.
The problem with that? Intermac's not like we're going to Texas or something.
I know, but it's still like an hour and a half away.
No, it ain't that far.
90-something miles.
Not think that long. You're on the motorcycle.
It's supposed to rain tomorrow.
You're going to wear your ring gear.
So what does Rafting say?
He was asking about the wall again.
Oh, okay.
Have you been to Annie Oakley's Chopper Shop? Is the Annie Oakley?
Yeah, that's right there.
That's the bar. We know where there's a bar at, but do they have a shop? Oh, have we been to Annie Oakley's Chopper Show? No, we have never have. Want to check it out this year, sponsored by Lowbrow. Lowbrow. No.
What day is it? We'll have to figure out what day it is. We can stop by there. He keeps saying he wants to stop by and look at it. Oh,
at the bar. And because I said there's always a lot of bikes out there. They must do the bike show behind it. Ron says Bay Meadows. No, well, I don't know. Whatever store is in, they consider the Jacksonville store. Is it the Bay Meadows? If you go to our Facebook page, Bob and Tam, I put it on there yesterday. And then after I found it this morning, I guess. Pomodoro's on. Okay, having a blast. We had trailer trouble this morning. More excitement on that. Besides, somebody, if you watched the video this morning, somebody did.
Stuff happens, right? I don't know. He said you'll get great service with either one.
He said he thinks it's the second Friday, which is better because it's not quite as hectic as the first weekend is.
What, when
the
Indian dealer is?
No, where they have the bike show at. Annie Oakley's Chopper Show.
If I can find it real quick.
There's a couple ones that are having antique shows. I think the Broken Spoke might be having an antique bike show. But I mean, that's what's tough about this stuff. It's so much stuff going on. It really makes it tough because now for the first Friday, it looks like we're going to probably go out to the track and check on, Sons of Speeds doing their, practice runs. We're trying to get a list of all the drivers or all the riders to find out to make sure we have everything all set up. Then we're looking for, and then after that, we're probably just going to go to the Cackle Berry.
Kamoto's on.
I already said that. And we're going to stay out there because it's Confederate Railroad's playing. I think it's 7 to 8:30. It's really early. Or it's 8 to 9:30. One of the two. It's really early. And so we're going to go watch that. And that'll probably be the end of the night on Friday. And Saturday's going to be nuts. Because now we're going to go to the Indian dealer first thing in the morning. See if we can catch that guy around 8:30. Hopefully he'll be there bright and early. And then from there, we got to go all the way out there in this new Smirnoff, whatever the hell they call it now, where the racetrack's at. Go there and be there sometime before 11:30 would be the goal. And so we can get in the pits and get that all set up. What else is going on? Weather's still great. It's hotter than heck out there.
Today I'd say it's hot. It's been warm, but the humidity hasn't been too bad. I don't know if it's because we moved today and lots of stuff happened and it was hot.
And we did eat that. The
Best Three Chopper Show doesn't say a day.
Get a new bike.
Friday, March 15th, 2 p.m. That's even after the show. Does it say the 15th?
Maybe it's last year. You look up here and see what it says on the top. Yeah, it's 2019. You're in the wrong year.
Well, that's the second thing, third thing that was up on their page.
You just ask Annie Oakley's.
That's what I said. Boogie Fest Chopper Show.
We'll just stop by there and see. But probably it's that last weekend. Because here, back in 2019, it was on the 15th.
Boogie Fest Chopper Show 2023.
And, hot as crap out of him. Ron says it is, too. He's hot down there. He's up there. I guess he's up there.
He's
I always
north.
Keep thinking St. Augustine is south. I don't know why. He just always
Well, when
that.
We get on the freeway to come up here to the dealership, because we're south, we're in Port Orange, and he always says, gotta go south. No, we gotta go north. It's like, I don't know why he's so twisted around.
You got models here today, see? We'll have one come up to you. Hey, hi, guys. How are you doing?
It's like a Barbie.
Probably a lot of Photoshop done there. One of the Indian dealer, they have a lot of used Harley motorcycles. That's about all I'm going to say. Look on the video. You'll see some of the... Yeah, actually, what's really shocking this year there's price tags on everything. At the Indian dealer, here, it's pretty cut and dry. You can see pretty much where I would start negotiating at. But I kind of looked at a few of the bikes here. I didn't really do any MSRP to check to see where they're at. But Teddy Morris is really going to adjust the prices here. He's going to go into very competitive with the other dealers around here. You know, South Coast or Space Coast. Some of the other ones that used to probably be Six Bends. And yeah, Adamac. Adamac sells a lot of bikes. So there's going to be a real war going on down here probably for selling bikes. Oh, so he's got Friday, March 10th at 2 p.m. I'd be able to do that if we remember. Other things going on. I haven't really looked at all the rallies yet. I've been putting posters up for this video that I'm getting ready to do, but I really haven't looked at other than Willie's. We went and talked to Willie yesterday. He's coming out to the shop. He's going to be coming out of the shop. Might be out there in January or February next year, checking us out. And it could be even after that. But we may be going in September. We may be going down to Bikes, Blues, and Barbecue. Neil says that girl looks like the girl that was on Pawamoto's video from a day ago. Could have been. Could have been.
She looks like Jessica Simpson to me. A little bit.
And they got sales going on. Probably a lot of sales will be over by the time you get here. They got a 10% off air intakes. And they got 15% off of something else. They got a whole bunch of products down here that Harley Davidson stuff that they got on sale. And so, yeah, they got a lot of bikes. We just got her on an interview yesterday, and she said this is the most bikes they've ever had for the rally. So that's kind of neat.
Especially there's, the last couple of years. There's Captain Adventure, how you doing?
We asked Shelly if she wanted to come on live, and she said, oh, no, I'm busy. See you later. So she ain't coming on. But I want to get over here and get the live out today. We'll do one tomorrow. It's going to be really early tomorrow. We're going to come on probably around between noon and 1 o'clock Eastern time. We're going to be over there at the stunt show. Maybe I'll show some of it live. Maybe I won't. We'll see how it all goes. And so we're probably not going to be on too long because we have to come back because one of our subscribers wants to take us out to dinner tomorrow night at 6:30. So we're going to get back here.
At their house, actually.
Yeah.
Komodo. He wants to know where it's going to be at, I guess. HD.
Any dates on Main Street as far as last year? Do you mean like anything new? No. Anything old? Is it still there? Right now it is. We'll have to wait till after Biketoberfest.
Everything seems to be the same as of this moment.
Yes. You know, I don't know if they're going to block the streets off or nothing like that. We can't get a hold of, well, we didn't even try to call it Daytona Cops. We're still working on our, the sheriff can't do nothing with us. We're still Ormond Beach when we went down because he hasn't called us back. We stopped down there the other day and they're like, he said he was calling you. And we went back and listened because we thought, well, maybe he called and it didn't come through and it got stuck on a voicemail. Went back, listened, wasn't there. So I'm going to tell you about that. And so we'll get it. We'll get him before the week's out. He'll wrangle us up here. And
he didn't interview with us until the rally had already started last year, I think, because the rally was already started before you put it up. Because you kept saying, I got to get this done right now so I can put it up because the rally's already started.
So, pretty exciting. This week's a lot of catch up. Monday, we're heading out to where they do the burning bike at Fastlane. We're going to be talking to him. We'll come back through Cackleberry there and see if he's there to see if we can talk to him and kind of see what's going on. And we'll probably go around town and see who's setting up. What we're hearing is most of the trucks and stuff are rolling in. Oh, awesome.
Boss
Hoss is over at. Hey. He can come on live.
Yeah.
You want to be live? Come around. He's actually one of our subscribers, but he also here working at the dealership. If you want to buy a bike, come ask for him.
Hey, we met last year up in Sturgis, and
we did.
This is who we're going to have dinner with on Sunday.
Yeah.
My wife's all excited.
There we go.
Yeah, great. We love Bob and Tam. They're awesome. I mean, no kidding, for real. I mean, it's a show, but they're on. They really are. And they're informative. If you really want to learn some stuff.
Yeah.
And we're going to have pizza.
Yep.
And I was told you like thin crust and pepperoni.
There you go.
So it's already ordered.
All right.
All right. Thank you.
All right.
If you need a bike, come see them.
Yep. Come see me.
Yep. So it'll make you a great deal while you're here. So check that out. They actually retired. They're actually from up in the East Coast, somewhere, like Upper New York or somewhere up that way, Connecticut, or I'm not quite sure. Somewhere up there. And they came down here for, they were looking to come down just for like 3 months and, you know, kind of hang out. They had an RV and stuff. Next thing you know, they got a house, and here they are.
They've reinvented themselves. They both had separate careers, and now they're totally something. Oh, he's the salesman.
John says, be wary of any spaghetti dinner invites. No, it's pizza.
Pizza.
And actually, we're already pre-tested on this because Adam from Amsoil Adam went and ate with them at their house.
Oktoberfest.
So he's so alive. He's alive. He's doing good. So we shouldn't have any problems.
So at least you know if we don't come back, that's who to look for.
Wanted poster. You can freeze it. We used to have Dawn. Was it Dawn that used to do that all the time? The other night she was on for a little while, but we haven't seen her since. She might be shadowing us, just watching what's going on. She's not talking. Yeah, ghosting, that's what it's called. Ghosting. She might be on there. And
so if you're on there, Dawn, hey.
And what's your other friend? She goes by initials.
Oh, SJS. Yeah, I haven't seen her in a while. Yeah. Every once in a while she'll be on. So, she usually texts me too. I haven't seen her.
Yeah. So we'll be heading to Myrtle Beach soon. So that'll be going on. 87 Ricer's on. And I found that out too. Found that out last night that you can do a lot of custom work on crotch rockets.
Well, my Palmotto was selling. I
had no idea. I didn't know nothing about it. But I guess any kind of motor, you can do stuff to it. But, you know, we were just talking about Harley's, how it's so much easier because parts are so readily available.
Neil says, give us a thumbs up.
Got a lot of bikes out here. They got Saints and Sinners.
Saints. And Sinners.
They have bands over there all weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. They got bands out here, a bunch of bikes. I filmed a little bit of that. It'll come up on one of the videos coming up soon, or maybe later. We're going to shoot a lot of footage. We're not going to end up showing you everything this trip. You're going to see a lot of this stuff after the fact because
we'll try to give you stuff daily, what we're going to do, what's going on that day. And then after it's all over, then we'll show all those.
And then we'll do some lives. Like I said, if we get the live going tomorrow, while the stunt show is still going on, I'll show you some of the stunt show and you can see some of that live. And we're going to try to do that this year. We're going to try to hit more of things going on. You know, the Iron Horse, the Broken Spoke, the Beaver Bar, down on Main Street, the Boot Hill Bar. They're celebrating their 50th anniversary this year. So we got a lot of neat stuff going on. You know, Cabbage Patch is going on. They are not selling coleslaw now. Everybody keeps telling me that lives around here, they used to. Roger that owns the place says we never sold coleslaw. Maybe there was some guy out there, one of the guys used to work for him. Maybe
he was
scooped
doing
it up
on the
and
side.
Sold it. Because when I said something about it, he kind of shook his head like, mm-mm. And the girl was in the bar was like, no. And because by the time it's over, it's all wilted and stuff. Because there's no milk or nothing in it products. It's all oil. Oil and lettuce.
Cabbage. Cabbage.
I think it's lettuce.
No, it's not. Slaw is made with
isn't made with oil either, though, but they're using it.
You can get coleslaw with oil and vinegar or mayonnaise. Comes both ways. You don't even eat the crap, so you don't know.
Milk products.
He's an expert on that, too.
My mom made it.
But you didn't eat it.
I can still see how she made it. Just because I don't eat it doesn't mean that I don't know how to make it.
Move on.
I can make a lot of things that I don't eat.
We had the best cake from Giuseppe's. He gave us dessert, too, and sent it home with us. He didn't like the chocolate one. He liked the dreamsicle cake.
It was okay. It was too much of it, though.
It was there. They're one of those cakes that are like gigantic, ginormous.
So the Iron Horse on Thursday at 5 p.m. We're going to have burnout contest. Winner gets a free tire and $250. That'd be good.
Well, at least you get a free tire because.
Yeah,
because
that's what's weird about here. There's not as much burnouts like you get in Sturgis. You know, everybody's doing it. But I mean, same thing there. It's the Iron Horse in Sturgis that does the burnouts. There's no Broken Spoke out there. So it's the same people that are running the Broken Spoke that runs Iron Horse out in Sturgis. So, yeah. But they're doing a bunch of work on it because we were going to go film that the other day. And he's like, oh, come on. It's a mess. I don't want to hear that on
camera.
There's
a lot of construction. It looked like there's a concrete cutout because they got a really cool area that's all lit up where they do the bike shows and stuff. But it's all like cobblestone, like the old bricks and stuff. So I hope they're not going to concrete over that.
It's a big mess going on. Well, see, that happened. What was it? Was it last year they didn't, in spring, they didn't have it open? They don't ever have Broken Spoke ever open during the Biketoberfest. But I think it was last year is the Broken Spoke wasn't. One year the Broken Spoke wasn't open. I don't know if it's 2020 or if it's 2021 or 2022.
That's been 2020.
That the Broken Spoke never opened. It looked like a
ghost town.
Yeah, it was like 10-foot weeds. But how many people will burn up a tire and lose? A lot.
Probably.
Go over to Suck Bang Blow and see how that one works.
I don't even know how many tire stores around.
That's the one part that drives me crazy more than anything else. First of all, I'm not going to smoke my tires anyway, if I could or I would. Not on a motorcycle. Car, I might, I used to do that, but not on a motorcycle. But almost.
You did it in the truck the other day.
I would say 90. Hey, you come on live.
I don't do it.
Here he comes. He's coming around. Say hi to everybody.
Hey.
This is
Hello.
Alan.
Welcome to Teddy Morse's HD.
In Daytona.
And he's our official greeter here. We've been seeing him for, right, it's the last 3 or 4 years we've been
Too many years,
haven't
we? Yeah. Go ahead. You can say too many years.
What do they call you? What's your nickname?
Walkie-talkie.
Because that's all he does.
Come on in and I'll talk to you and I'll walk with you. I'm ambidextrous that way.
There you go. What a deal.
He does a little bit of everything.
That's right. Yeah. Come on in real soon.
He used to always be the greeter out by where you brought your service bikes in. But this year, he's doing everything.
How many hats do you wear?
Yes.
Yes.
All of them. All of them.
So whatever you need.
Come on in. Let's walk and talk.
There you go.
We'll see you.
So another one of the great people here, and we've met a lot of, which it is, when you come to these dealerships like this, you hang out around, you end up meeting certain people that just kind of click with them, and he's always been a great guy. He's been, I guess he lives here too. He's lived here for a long time.
Yeah, they moved down here. He told us a lot better to do.
And so when we first came, he told us a lot of different places to go to and check out and things like that, and could have just asked me to pass him.
Well.
The fellow over. Hi. There he is. Hey. Come around. You can get on our live.
Joey's here.
You get a free plug. So here's Joey from All About Customs. He's got his trailer out here. You're out riding, aren't you?
I'm just out riding, trying to enjoy it.
Where'd you go? What's the best ride you've done so far since you've been here?
I think Kurt took us out toward the lake, which is about an hour and a half from here, probably more inland toward the middle of the state. So got a little riding in and went visit a few people, and I even worked on a bike already.
We gotta go see him on Wednesday.
Wednesday we'll come over. Yeah. All righty. And pretty exciting. And should be starting tomorrow. We'll start seeing the trucks rolling in.
A few of them starting to roll in. I've kind of got mine somewhat in place. I'll lock it in Monday. All my guys will be here Monday. We'll start putting the awnings and stuff up and getting ready.
Sounds good.
Tell everybody what you do.
We install dirty air rides, native fat tire kits, fat baggers, handlebars, clockwork windshields, saddleman seats, mostly things to make your bike make you comfortable on your bikes.
One of the things that somebody complained about my fat tire video I did on yours, he says, you know, one thing that nobody ever shows is putting that front axle in, how hard it is to put it in. I said, well, that whole video, we cut it down shorter anyway, but it didn't take you that long to put the axle in. So we're going to have to just film you slide an axle and show how easy it is to put it in for you.
Yeah.
How it lines up for you.
I don't remember how long that video was, but
it was pretty quick altogether, but I mean, you got to cut it all down because.
Is there certain bikes it's harder to put the fat tire? No?
No, not really. Just a matter of kind of lining it up and sliding her in.
Yeah. It wasn't that big a deal. And that's what I said. Whoever commented on it was just the other day. And he said, that's what he said. He says, every video I always watch people do that, they never show putting the axle in. And I'm like, well, I don't know. It was just something. He did have a little trouble with your help. But I mean, it was still probably just a couple of minutes and it was in.
Yeah.
It wasn't like.
No big deal. I think one of the guys I had last year when we done that video, he was new to us. So,
yeah.
You know, each person had their own little part. Yeah. Once I broke it down, I ended up having somebody go put the rotors on the new tire and rim that we broke and put the cans in first. You know, it was ready to go back together.
So that's
take us less than 30 minutes.
So that's who's going to be doing the handlebars. I have not decided which one we're going to get, but he's got a couple of bikes over there with different handlebars, and we're going to check them all out and figure out which one we got. We did get our new heated grip, so I got those.
Okay.
Some Harley ones we picked up.
We have a good set of handlebars. I might try. We call them reduced reach.
Okay.
And they're for what we basically 5'9", 5'10" guys.
Okay.
Shorter girls and women that like to ride and want to get some bars up. They're reduced reach. Okay. And then the older guys that are, you know, we're all getting up in age a little bit when we can't handle that bike as well as we used to be able to. So
that's good.
It works out good. I sell a lot of reduced reach bars.
All right, okay. Cool.
So we'll be checking that out. We'll have a video on that sometime. I don't know if it'll come up before the rally's over or not, but we'll try to get it up. And we're going to be doing a bunch of videos with him while we're out here this week. So I'll have a bunch of stuff showing you some different things they do. And I don't know if we ever really did an air ride. But he's got a.
Yeah, that one girl. Remember, she was all excited when she came back?
Yeah. That was in Myrtle Beach, I guess.
I think she had a street glide special, and
she was short.
She was just had a really hard time backing it up. So, yeah, she was all excited when she got it.
Yep. We got her on camera.
Can see. Yep.
All right, guys. All right. See y'all in a couple days.
All right. You have fun.
Thank y'all.
All right. Take care.
So, that's Joey. It's all about customs. Really great guy. He's very, very, I don't want to say anal, but he's very particular when he does his installs.
He's a perfectionist.
That he shows meticulous. Us, which he doesn't want us to film it, but he shows us some of these bikes that some of these other guys do with air ride
come
and stuff.
Come on up, Roadkill Run.
And it's just a mess that comes in there. And he says, look at this stuff. And I'm like, let me put it on camera. He says, no. I don't want to, I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. And because he says sometimes like that, if you take your bike, well, it's like anything. You have a bunch of people do your wiring and you take your fairing off and it all falls out. It just kind of jammed it all in there. You want to make sure when you get stuff done like that, you want to make sure people are zip tying things. They're rolling things up tight. They're doing a proper ground on it. They're not just grounding to some bolt that they find on the frame someplace to ground to. Make sure they're grounding it to like the battery source or where the battery cable goes to, the ground cable, where you're getting a good source of a ground that you're not going to have something fail on you. And also the wires are someplace that's not going to get burnt. They're not going to get pinched. They're not going to be rubbing on something where they're going to wear on it. There's a lot of that, especially, and it doesn't have to just be for vendors like this at a rally. A lot of people do this crappy work at their shops. Questions?
No. Neil wants to know if we found the chicken bone lady yet.
We're in the wrong state now, or wrong city.
She's in Lakeland. Unless she moved over here to the East Coast side of Florida.
So far we've gone to today wasn't
went to Colts.
Yeah, we've ate there before and it's been pretty good. Today just wasn't real hot. But I mean we're in between lunch and dinner. We just ate a few minutes ago. And it just wasn't the fries were kind of rubbery and the meat was kind of fatty and it tasted all right, but it just I don't know. I was actually hog heaven down there. It ended up being really, really good.
Yep.
And I don't think I know this or not.
Oh, I don't know. I wasn't watching.
Who'd you say was supposed to come by?
Roadkill Ron. He says, if you're going to be there for about 20 minutes, I'll head down.
Oh, yeah, we'll be here.
Yep. So I told him, Roadkill Ron, if you're still on, we'll wait for you. Come on down.
Yeah, we're going to be here about an hour.
At least. It's already been on 30 minutes.
Okay. But we'll probably be here a little more than an hour. They're open here till 6, and we wanted to just get alive. We don't really have anything else to do tonight. Just go back and my Indian laundry. Stuff. Yeah, she had to get to do laundry sometime between tonight and tomorrow.
All right, he's going to start going commando.
That's right. We'll be swinging. Bring them in the trees.
Mike Skidmore's on. He said, I don't know. I need my glasses on. I can't see. It was all white here this morning in Michigan. Then the sun came out and the snow melted again. They do that all the time, I guess.
Come on down to Florida. Come on down to Florida.
Ron, Emory HVAC, sent me a picture this morning of Delaware.
All the trees.
It was just a dusting, but it was nice.
All the trees.
I said, well, it looked pretty. I said, are you going to catch motorcycle rides at Daytona? We're working on that. We're kind of at a standstill, but we'll see. I was thinking, if anything else, you could do the VIP package, and I could just sit out there with Katie, and you can go in by yourself, and we only have to buy one. Happy work is the American way. It begins with a... I'm coming, Roadkill Ron says. Okay, we'll see you in a little bit. Not how long it takes you to get here, but we'll be here. I think you just get a bunch more countries with the bigger plan. That's it. Just see if they just do Mexico.
No, it's we don't really. You can always upgrade it.
I guess. Can't wait to get there Sunday. Glad rally season is back. Yeah, I think you said you were at the Clarendon here, weren't you? 6? I don't remember. Thursday, I mean. Oh, okay. So she'll be here Thursday. Oh, this Thursday. So you'll be here the day before the rally starts? Had freezing rain a few days ago. Thousands out without power, trees down in the Midwest. This year has been crazy. I don't know. It's even been cold out on the West Coast.
Global warming.
Never. God, that's who it is.
Somebody's got a screaming kid that needs to shrek that kid. Our kids never scream like that.
They didn't.
Must have gave them a good wallop. And they were screaming.
Well, because I used to tell my kids, if I would see a kid having a fit in the store, I'd say, look at those bad kids. Do you see those bad kids? They're not good kids. They're bad kids. And my kids never. Knock on wood. I was very blessed.
So I did find out some interesting information about rental bikes from Eagle Rider.
New Zealand's on.
So to give you an idea of what, right now they do have some bikes for rent. They got some from the 3rd to like the 7th, and then they have some in the middle of the week. I don't think they have anything at the end of the week. They have a couple of road glides that are available right now. Bad news is, for 3 days, you're looking at about $1,200 to rent the bike. That includes all your insurances, full coverage insurance, includes road hazard. It can, well, I don't know why they give you road hazard, but towing and everything's included with that $1,200. So if you're interested, and you can actually pick it up here at Teddy Morris's Harley Davidson. They actually have a look. The Eagle Rider just has a warehouse right over here. They said it's on the other side of the pavilion. So it must be one of those little rental units back there. They must have bikes back there. So you can pick them up right here during the rally. So if you're still interested, you can go to Eagle Rider and you can rent a bike from them if you want something new. If you don't mind having a little bit older Harley, you can always go over there to Midwest is it Cycle?
Midwest Motorcycles.
We'll see. Midwest Motorcycles down on Beach. That's Heavy Ed, and he's gonna come on. He's gonna be on the video that comes out Monday, and we don't give any prices. I didn't ask him, but he's
Tom Motors has way more than his BMW rental. So yeah. Graham, email us your information. We'd love to meet up with you. Also, he's from New Zealand. He's going to Sturgis this year.
Yeah, we met somebody last year from Moran, and he kind of came over from watching our videos. Came all by himself, and he got a tent. And he was camping with a bunch of people. And I said, well, did you make some friends and stuff? And he's like, he's seen us and he come walking up and he's like, can I talk to you? And we're like, okay, yeah. And he says, I watch your channel. He says, I'm from Moran. And I said, wow. And he flew over to Washington. I think he came in the state of Washington. And then
rented
a bike from there and he rode over by himself. And he met a bunch of guys there and they were all going out riding and stuff and having a good time, which you always do. You know, a lot of people always say that, you know, I don't know if I want to go or not. You know, it's a little lonely getting to the rally, but you know, once you get there and you know, it's not, you know, as long as you don't really break down, knock on wood, we've been really, really lucky. We've never, well, like, other than going up to Big Sur and we had a blowout on the tire that was installed improperly.
That wasn't going to Sturgis though.
Yeah, I wasn't going to Sturgis, but I mean, we still, it ruined the whole trip. We were down for 3 days because it happened over the 4th of July weekend. And it was like Monday, I think, was the 4th of July. So dealer closed at 5.
Tuesday.
Because they're
closed on
Sunday
Mondays.
Sunday and Monday. We got there on Saturday. We got there like 20 minutes after they closed. We called them. They said, you know, we got to pay the guys. We'll hang around like 5 or 10 minutes. That's it. But we were 100 miles away on a beach highway, the PCH, trying to get from Big Sur to
Gilroy,
and got there late, and there was a motel right next door, and I said, just drop the bike there at the hotel so I can still see it. They said, well, we can put it by the door. I said, well, I'm not leaving the bike set out there for 2 days by itself.
Well, Sunday they were closed, Mondays they were closed, and Tuesday was 4th of July.
So it wasn't
Wednesday until I got to it.
Yeah, and then we already had hotels paid for, and ended up being the guy to put the tire on, which is very shocking. But we do have some pretty good people. And I don't really want to say the guy's name. If you're ever down in Southern California and you need to get a tire, I can tell you who it is. But he had to bring the tire back in the tube because I had spoke wheels on my bike. And he swore, well, the Harley dealer said it was a bad valve stem that was in the tube. It came loose. And the guy on the phone was like, I don't think that's what happened to it. You bring all that back and I'll look at it all. So I brought it all back. He took it in the shop. Came right back and he said, my new man pinched the tube. But what was scary about it was we rode probably 100 miles on the highway and it was fine. Once we got on the PCH up by Morro Bay, started getting on all the twisties and stuff, that's when, I guess because the tires started moving and the tube started moving, that's what popped it. And we almost ended up about 500 feet drop off on one side and the other side was all big rock cut out. She was just about telling her, about ready to jump off the bike because I couldn't stop it. I was going to hit one of those big concrete things they put in between the highways when they're doing construction work. I was going to hit for that. And I ended up finally getting it stopped before, because we had just got a brand new tire on the back. So I was thinking it was my front tire that was causing the problem because it was wobbling in the front. And I kept getting off the bike and looking at it. Well, I never looked at the back tire. So I'm like, brand new. Why would I look at it? So then when I was going down this hill,
I kept hitting
the
back
brake, and the tire actually came off the rim. So I'm hitting it, and of course, it's doing nothing. Well, finally, I must have grabbed a hold of the front, and that's how I I had about a foot away from this hitting this. And I was already off into the chat and heading for it. And yes, that was, I don't know.
Quite an experience.
That's probably about 15 years ago, too. I don't know. Been a long time, 10 to 15.
So, yeah, when we joined the hog group, when we first got our bike, that was, we made some great friends, and there's a lot of them are still our friends. Don't see them very often.
That's how I know Art. If it wasn't for us joining the hog group, I wouldn't have my buddy Art.
That's what he said when he bought his Harley. He joined the local hog group.
And it depends on, because the other one that we had, we were, our store, Riverside, which used to be Skip Fordyce, which is owned by somebody else we don't recommend, but they had another store that was in Corona. It was a satellite store, but they sold bikes and all that stuff. It was just like a regular dealership, but just a little smaller. And so we started going there, and they just started the hog group. And their rule was ride and have fun. They weren't going to raise money. They weren't going to do benefits. They weren't going to do crap. Go ride and have fun. And that's what it was all about. And it was. We rode a lot. Every weekend we rode. We rode an average of 300 to 500 miles with them every weekend. And
all, every day, Saturday and Sunday.
They had rides going on, all kinds of neat stuff. And we went to other people's events that were, they had stuff going on in California, other Harley dealers and stuff like that.
And if we just did a local ride, we'd come back, and then they'd always have, like, giveaways. You'd always get a ticket when you went to ride. And then they'd have, with those towels, and it's hanging in the bathroom out in the garage.
And they had all kinds of gifts they gave away.
Sandoval's riding to 120 dealerships this summer, and anyone can join his convoy for as many stops as they want to.
You have to pay to go on the rides. That's his stipulation.
Once they get there.
No, if you want to ride, like, let's say I want to ride all 120 rides with Adam. I've got to pay at every stop. I have to pay whatever it costs to go on that benefit ride. It's $40. If it's $40, $50, whatever the benefit is, you have to pay that. That's your cost to ride with him from dealer to dealer. That's the way I took it from what he was explaining the other day. Adam's a great guy, but
he's raised a lot of money.
He's wanting to raise, like, I think $1 million or something. So he's really pushing to get as much as he can out of people that want to do the rides.
He's got a goal.
Adam's not a bad guy. And I don't know how he hasn't really been doing a lot of the old camping like he used to do, sleeping on the side of the road and behind a gas station. And, you know, when he had what was the dog's name? Cooter. Not Scooter. Scooter. Scooter was from Dukes of Hazzard. But Scooter.
Oops.
Which we met.
Holy cow.
You didn't pet Scooter unless Scooter wanted to be petted.
Oh, yeah.
Typical Chihuahua.
We did have a little Chihuahua this morning. We got to pet. He was nice. Bunny King Hog in UK has a front new tire install, went on a trip. Many spokes were loose and had major wheel failure. And the trip, they went to Germany. Some HD gear head in Germany picked there.
Fixed it.
I guess. Fixed there.
Well, yeah, there's anytime you're on the road,
anything can always happen. Right. Everybody's human.
You can have a bad. That's why we've been really lucky that we never had a dead battery to either. And we just did that little video I did the other day on that bike jumper. And so that's pretty neat. We got it actually in the truck right now, but when we go biking, we'll throw that in the bike. It's small enough, possibly could charge the phones up with it, or if we were going to do a live and we didn't have enough power, we could use that. So it's got a lot of really neat features. And for something that, I don't know if the price went up or not, it was $59.95. It's worth having something, and it's a lithium battery. It'll hold a charge. It's not like, you know, some of the stuff you put in your bike, next thing you go, time you go back and get it, it's dead.
When you need to use it, it's dead.
And you don't have time to charge it.
So he said, if you meet him at a dealership, he'll enter you to win the bike.
Oh yeah,
he's going to give that bike away.
Yep.
That he's riding.
Yep, I did see that too. You're correct.
Bike up in a trailer, back to his house, feed him, put him away, and parts replace the rear tire.
And so that's the only bad thing when you're traveling. Same with us. When we've always rode the bike to Sturgis, that's our longest ride is ever to Sturgis. And from Southern California, when we rode there, that's what we always did, was I always had everything planned out. Now, most of the time, we didn't drive a lot of miles. Our first time we went, we took like 5 days to get there, because we had never been on a long trip, and we had no idea what it was going to be like. You know, we drove 300 or 400 miles in a day, but we never, you know, you just don't know, because
we'd go to the mountains and come back home. So we were always back home at
same
the end
day.
Of the day.
But we went with the Harley group, and they'd go on a ride, and we'd be gone for a day. But the same thing, they didn't really ride that far either in one day, 200, 300 miles in a day. So it wasn't a long. So when we first started out, I had no idea how long it would take us. And then I'm one of these people that do like to stop. If I see something on the way and we've got time scheduled, I'll stop. You know, if it's like when we go up California, I love it, because I want to do rides in California, but right now the highway's all screwed up. The PCH is still half collapsed. But I was going to take a bunch of you guys if you want to go on a ride.
Yeah, that would be cool.
No obligation. There's no fee. There's nothing that I charge you. It's whatever it costs for the hotels that I book, and you just ride along. And but I stop at a lot of stuff.
I'll show you
a lot of great places. We've seen moose and elk and turkeys and
bears. Oh my, we did see a bear.
Yep.
One finally saw a bear. By the time we both went, what is that? Oh, it's a bear. We're looking for the camera and he was gone.
Yeah. Well, we just came around the corner and the bear kind of looked at us. He was pretty big. It was like about twice size of a big dog. Yeah. And he just kind of looked at us and we looked at him
and he was gone.
And that's the first bear we've seen.
We want to be at a Mac by noon. Because that's when the stunt show starts. Yeah. So I'll call you when we leave down here.
Yeah. So we're going to leave. What's he want us to go by there and pick him up?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, I don't know. We're probably going to go. We're going
to
go back.
We have to go through St. Augustine to go up there.
So if he wants to ride along. I'll just see how long it is. We have to be there before noon. So I want to get there at least by 11:30. So that way we're there in plenty of time. Set my cameras up and all that kind of good stuff. I'll be ready to shoot.
And work then in a rally because... of that reason. No, that's why Neil says he doesn't like it. Mike says we missed the point that the guy that replaced the tire didn't spot her loose spokes. So he didn't really cause the loose spokes. He just should have seen that.
The loose spokes caused the tire to go flat.
Yes. So, yeah. It depends on your help. And like I said, you never can tell. At some places, some people go and say they have a great experience.
Like, it's like this Corona Harley dealer. So I can talk about them. They're gone. So I took my bike in there to get an oil change. So I'm like, hey, you know, I just got this bike. I actually bought it in Las Vegas. And I'm like, hey, can you guys go ahead and do my oil change for me? At that time, I had a really good job. I didn't have time. When I got home from work, I didn't want to do nothing. Didn't have a lot of tools. I sold all my tools when we moved to California because I thought I never wanted to work on anything again.
Hey, Rod.
And so I took my bike to the dealership, had an oil change done on it. And I pulled out of the dealership, and the next day, somebody kind of looked at the front of my bike and said, man, your front brakes are almost completely wore out. And I looked down, I'm like, holy crap, why didn't the dealer say something? If they would have said something, I would have paid the $50 or $100 for them to throw new pads on the front. Well, I go back in next day, and I said, like I bought the pads from them. And I said,
they didn't balance it then, huh?
I said, what's the deal? I said, don't you guys check the bikes out when you get an oil change done? They said, oh, no, unless you ask for something. You're missing the golden opportunity because most people, if you're bringing a bike into the shop and unless it's a major overhaul or something like that, but I mean, if you were in there and you know, you're getting ready to go on a ride or something like that. And they say, oh, by the way, I want to let you know your front forks are leaking. You know, while you're here, we can go ahead and knock it out right now. And we'll have it done yet today for you. And, you know, or I can pick it home and either I can do it myself or I could go find somebody else to do it. But if I wanted to, I'm planning on going riding this weekend. Oh, yeah, I'll pay the extra money to have the dealer do it and be done with it. That way it's fixed and I don't have to worry about it. Plus, they caught it for me, you know, something I didn't know. And when I used to be in automotive, we were like that. When I first started in automotive, we never looked at anything. We just did whatever people asked for. But ends up being 99% of the people
that rides a
motorcycle or drives a car or a truck, whatever it is, they're not mechanically inclined. Plus, you lift a car or a motorcycle up on a rack, you're going to see a whole lot more stuff wrong than you are when you just kind of look under the car under the road. You know, look under your driveway and say, okay, there's no oil dripping, no antifreeze. Everything must be good. Well, my truck was like that the other day. I was underneath it and I was like, oh, crap, I got shocks are going bad on my truck. Just, she thought I had to instantly put shocks on my truck. It ain't going down the road like that. It's 3/4 ton. Shocks don't do a lot much for it anyway. It's like a log wagon.
So Rod says he's coming down, so you'll have to let us know when you get down here.
Rod who?
Rod that we stayed with in New Hampshire.
Yeah, is he on his way?
He said, I'm on the way down to Florida and getting out of this huge storm. Mike says, Bunny King Road at Hognail had a new tire put on their local dealership before they took out on the small country to Switzerland and Germany, etc. Yeah. I don't know. Stuff happens. You think people would catch stuff like that, especially if they work on vehicles and motorcycles or whatever, they'd be able to spot that. But I guess everybody's got to start somewhere and learn new. And I don't know. It's unfortunate.
Bringing kids back.
I don't think they left.
They were over there by the barbershop.
Yeah.
I don't know. They're trying to get the kids. Some little kid to get the haircut. Maybe they're getting the kids' first haircut.
They shaved it. Oh, he gave him a mohawk.
I don't see the hawk. Well, I guess he does.
Pep Pink says, for sure, you guys coming up from the north, please ride safe. All right. I don't know if we're going to take the bike or the... He says it's supposed to rain tomorrow, so I don't know.
I was going to look at the weather.
What are they telling you now? Invisible.
10-day forecast for...
Hey! Daytona. Roadkill Run, how you doing? Oh, we're good.
Here's the forecast.
You want to get on live? No? Oh my gosh, did you just get here then?
Oh, here's the weather.
Where are you staying there?
Tomorrow in Daytona, it's going to be 84 degrees. Monday is going to be 84. Tuesday is going to be 86. Wednesday, it's going to be 85. See what else we got going on here. Thursday, it's going to be 88. Friday, it's 87, and it's going to be cloudy. And then Saturday next week is going to be 76. Oh, holy crap, it's a cold wave. And then Sunday, it's going to be 74. Can you believe it? And then it's going to be 60 at night. We're going to have to get the winter coats out. But next, and then Monday on the 6th, it's going to jump up to 80 again. So we'll have to take the coats off. So how's the weather sound to you, wherever you're at?
Most anybody else is probably pretty good. There's Roadkill Run.
And so.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. 2 inches of ice up here. No shorts yet, but they're packed.
I do have shorts on. I had them on pants earlier. I didn't ride my bike today. Yes, I had to move over to the other campground. We're going to get on the bike and ride today. And I decided to come out here. And what's this thing was called?
Oh, the civilian rodeo.
Yeah. They have a thing where the guys ride like old police bikes and they're able to stop the bike. I got the guy one doing it. He was making a turn with it and doing, he never touched the ground and going around the cone. And I don't know how they
stop and then they turn and go and. Yeah. I mean, I don't know how they do it.
They got a course that for 6 months. I don't know what it costs you to take the course. But in 6 months, they can have you doing this, these stunts and stuff on the bikes. And it's more control of the bike. We've seen it the first time we ever seen it was in Sturgis. We were doing it on
that
Victories.
Would be scary, too. Yeah, they say the lower center of gravity, the easier it is to do.
And it's a Victories are always probably the ideal bike. Hi, but if you, the cop bikes that you get, which they sell here, used ones, yep. that... You have to have that, or you have to have your bike changed to be able to be like a cop bike.
They've got their whole second floor, I think, is used bikes, isn't it?
Yes.
So they have quite a selection of used bikes.
Yeah.
Indian has a good selection of Harleys at the Indian dealer, too.
And what's crazy is everybody's got their price tags on it. So it's easy to kind of look at it and see what they're normally selling it for. Oh, we found a Fat Boy Low, but it had a 110 motor on it. What the hell is a fat boy have a 110 motor on?
Somebody else had a...
I think when I test drove one time...
Never had a 110. Might have had a 107 or 103, which you would never have.
It was 114, I think. Because they had one had a 107, one had a 114. But it was the last year they made it. So I don't know if it was 2017. It was the last year they made the Fat Boy Lows. I'll be there Saturday morning. Weather sounds great. There you go. We're trying to hold on to this weather for as long as we can for you guys.
They were predicting rain on Tuesday, and now, right now, looking at this, it's gone. Right now, that high's been here, so I guess it's going to get a little cloudy and stuff on, but the little bit of a cold front comes through. We'll have to see by tomorrow, we'll see what Tuesday weather, the 7th, is going to be, and if it keeps going, building back up, that way, hopefully, this one won't get rained out like it did last year. And halfway through the rally, it got rained. That's why you really want to do as much stuff as you can when you first get here. If the weather's good, take advantage of your ride and seeing all the vendors and seeing all the things you want to do in case it does rain.
Yeah.
Because it's no fun running around the vendors and looking at stuff when it's pouring down rain.
I bet you that was really scary for her because one time we were driving. I don't remember where we were at. I think Art was with us. And we were going around these curves. And it was right after that tire incident we had. And my bike kept acting really squirrely. In the back, it felt like it kept... And I kept slowing down and slowing down. So finally he stopped. Art was behind me. And he's like, what is wrong? I said, I think my tire is flat or something because it was really low. And I guess they call them road snakes. It's when they tar the roads.
Oh, yeah.
And that's what I kept hitting. And my back tire kept like fishtailing. It scared me.
Tar snakes. Tar baby snakes.
No, they said road snakes, I think is what people call
them. Tar snakes.
Whatever.
Tar baby snakes.
Tar baby. You know who Tar Baby
is. Yeah, he used to be a dog. A friend of ours had a dog. He was called
Tar
Baby.
Do you find during your travels that bikers these days don't know how to work on their own bikes? 50-50, I bet.
Yeah. It just depends on... Well, you can usually tell what kind of bike somebody rides. Pretty much if you have a newer bike, it's tough to do... It's like me. I can do a lot of stuff on my bike, But it's do you have, like, for instance, doing a cam job and things like that? If you want to put the chain on, you got to have all those, checking out the roundout and all that stuff, the movement and everything. And those tools are very expensive.
He said the 15, 16 Fat Boys had 110s on them.
Can't hardly believe they had that on there.
I don't know.
I would never buy another bike with a 110.
7 degrees this morning here. 80 sounds fantastic, Rod says.
Come on down.
He's on his way. There are any bikers now, only riders.
And there's people that work on their bikes, but normally you end up seeing people, unless it's somebody that's got a bunch of bikes in their garage. It's kind of like, I watched a video a little bit of Monkey Man the other day about his Sportster. I don't know if he does it by himself. I don't know if when he'll ever get that done. That's I would never want to tackle.
That's just a lot of work to take on by yourself.
Yeah. If it was a bike, like let's say you bought it and it was already a chopper and somebody had already had it done, but it was maybe they didn't put really good parts on it, or maybe the motor didn't work right, to where you could work on each thing. Like him, he tore that hole. What if you are? You're watching, you already know what he's done. But I mean, that's just a lot of work. Well, and
if you're retired and don't have anything else to do, go for it. But I mean, he's got a job and a family and vodka and, oh my gosh, and YouTube he does. So, and then trying to do that too, that just seems like such a huge undertaking.
It would be, which it is. If you had all the time in the world, then yeah, you could probably sit down there. He's mechanically inclined enough to do it. But you
150s, that's it. You can't buy a 2 or 350. He said he heard Ford was selling all their trucks at $7,000 over invoice because they have such a huge inventory. But I bet it's only the 150s.
It's only 150s. Nobody's getting it. I don't know why they're not making 250s and 1 tons. They say Chrysler's got some dualies out there if you're looking for if you want a Chrysler.
I think it's the age group that's coming out. They said people really don't care what they do anymore. They're there to do a job, and if they have to do something, they'll do it. And if they don't then...
Everybody thinks, especially the younger crowds now, all think they're entitled. So if I'm going to work here, I'm going to, why are you making me work? Why can't I play on my phone? Why? What are you making? You mean I got to tighten up spokes on wheels? I thought I just had to put a stupid tire on this bike. Why do I have to do this? Why do I have to do that? So it's really, 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 that's why if you find a good mechanic, you want to hang on to that guy. You want to make sure that when you go, if you go to, let's say you came here all the time, you like to get your bike worked on. You should ask, who works on my bike? Was it Joe or was it Ted or who was it that worked on my bike? That way you know that, next time you come in, like let's say you had a bunch of work done and you find out Joe worked on my bike, which I don't know if there's a Joe here or not, and he did a good job, then you might, when you come back next time, say, hey, what is Joe here this week? I'd like to set my appointment up. I want him to work on my bike. It's just like these vendors out here. When I go to these vendors, there's people I would not let touch my bike. I would let the vendor do work, but I say, I want this guy to work on my bike. I want that guy to work on my bike. Because by standing there and watching them, you can kind of see, the kid that just started working. And it's kind of like what Joey had just a while ago. We filmed the fat tire. Well, Joey was right there with the guy, so the guy didn't do nothing wrong. But it was just a young kid trying to walk. And he had a little trouble putting that front axle in. It went through a couple times, and he kept hitting the side. And finally, they got it through. But he was being trained by Joey, so it wasn't left. But there's a lot of these places out here, and even dealerships and things like that. They'll have, might not be a young kid. It could just be somebody that doesn't have a lot of experience working on stuff that they don't even know what they're doing.
I know. More people, if they'll write a complaint in a heartbeat if something goes wrong, or they'll go complain. But what I try to do is if we find somebody with excellent customer service, or somebody did a really good job or treated us right or fixed something for, don't worry about it. They put a small part on or gave us a screw or whatever. I always try to go to a manager or go online and try to give them a kudos, because you don't find that very often.
More people will complain than compliment. Even if you're just okay with the guy, well, you're better off writing, hey, I had just good service. It wasn't excellent, but it wasn't bad. Today we're not somebody, because we worked in the food industry when we were really young, 16 years old and stuff. And we know back then you really don't want to
tick anybody off.
You
don't want to
send
industry
food back to the kitchen. I'm going to leave it at that, because you really get grossed out with some of the things. And I actually worked in a Catholic organization that wasn't uncommon that the steak ended up hitting the floor a couple times before they finished cooking it again. And the guy ate it. And That's why when I used to work at the, I only ate at the buffet that we had at the Catholic organization because I knew all that food was cooked once. It's put in the pan, it's done. And I stood there. I was in charge of the buffet when it was a gravy job, keeping the pans full.
They got if you want a new one, they got a bunch of triglides here. They said, that what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 6 I can see.
And right, they got more coming in. They got a bunch of bikes. Because this, what's bad about Florida is
the brand new ones,
there's
though.
A lot of trikes that get sold during this time. They had a lot of trikes over at, not as many Harleys as they usually have over at the Indian dealer, but they had an Indian trike there, which, of course, it didn't come that way. And they had a Honda Interstate or whatever it was, Goldwing trike that was there. I didn't look at the prices of either two of those. I filmed them. When you watch the video on Monday, you'll see those bikes. There, they had a lot of Harleys. They probably had 50, 60 used Harleys, everything, nothing. They had some 22s, and actually prices weren't real bad.
So somebody's asking about the winner of the 4-day tent stay.
Oh, we forgot to mount that.
I guess Rod wants to know if he won.
We already called her. We called the owner or the owner. Winner. We called the winner this morning and made sure everything was okay because we didn't want anything to happen because we're coming down to the draw here. We didn't want anything to happen that, oh, I can't get off. Well, it ends up being his wife may not be able to get off, but he's like, screw it, I'll go by myself. And he's, so what's his name?
Michael Nolan.
He's the official winner. He's from Kentucky and he's going to ride down here. It's a 12-hour ride on his bike. So he's going to be riding down maybe, here and he'll be getting
maybe
here
his
on
son
Friday.
Might come with him.
Yeah. But he said, not, I've done it on my own. And he actually, last year, he rode all the way to Sturgis by himself. He said, screw it.
He said he couldn't find any buddies to go with him. Yeah. He said,
he's like, screw it. I'm going.
Won't be the first time. Won't be
so
the last.
So you'll get to meet him. next week, we'll do a live from there. And you guys will get to meet him, our winner there. And what we basically did was the people that got on our email, there was a dozen or two. I don't remember how many there was. But what I did is I counted them all up. And I looked at her last night and I said, pick a number between 1 and 30. And 1 and 30 is included. So pick what number there. And she said, was it 6?
I don't know.
Whatever number she said, I counted back down. I said, okay, this is the guy that won. I highlighted it.
I had
it.
No idea whose name was.
Yeah, she didn't look at the emails. So I said, that way, instead of drawing a name out, I said, just pick a number.
Because then I would have had to write them all down, put them in a bag.
So she never looked at the emails. I was keeping track of the emails last night as they were coming in and looking at them. Because we also had other people asking.
My fault you didn't win.
And so we were looking because Palomoto was writing me too and asking stuff. So his emails were stuck in there too. So we didn't count him. And so I had other people that was writing us too about different things. Hey, we're coming down, what day they're coming down, and all this kind of stuff. So I only counted the people that said, hey, I want to win and I can come. I'm okay. Yeah. And I had one guy I would have almost gave it to on my own because they wrote a really nice email and said, hey, I'd really like to come. And if I don't win, I can't come. And I didn't tell her that. I didn't tell her what anybody wrote.
No, I didn't know anybody who I just picked
up. But this guy had a really good email. When I seen it, I was like, well, this is a guy I would have picked just because of his, if you know what Trunk Monkey is, Google Trunk Monkey on YouTube and watch the videos. And that's what this guy's email is. It's Trunk Monkey and some numbers and something else. I'm not going to give you his email, but it was Trunk Monkey. And I'm like, there's my kind of guy. I love those videos that they
trunk
put out
monkey
of Trunk
Monkey videos.
Yeah. Trunk Monkey. If you've got time and you want to laugh and have fun, you can Google it. And some dealer, I don't know how they got away with doing these commercials and the dealerships, you know, the factory didn't complain about them. But Google Trunk Monkey.
Oh, does she?
After you get off here.
Rapping says his wife's got a recluse clutch on his trike. And she loves it.
A recluse clutch. Oh, I know. That's the automatic.
I know. Well, you said you were going to get
people,
it. And then...
Well, Speed told me it was junk. How many miles has she put on it since she's had it?
I don't know. How many miles does she have on it, Rat Pink?
On the new recluse clutch.
Yes. So I don't know if he's on right now or not, who? But that Mike Nolan.
Oh, I don't know.
Michael Nolan. But yeah.
I don't think he really was. I don't think I've ever seen, but he's been watching us since last year in Sturgis. He started watching us. So I don't think he's somebody that normally comments. I think, which it is. We are like that.
Yeah.
Most of the videos I watch, unless I come in there and like we're sitting in the back, we got the TV on or whatever, and we're watching on the TV.
Kill Ron's probably over there at Saints and Sinners. He said there's a great band out here. We heard him earlier. I think it's an all girl band, isn't it?
I don't know. I didn't get that.
There's a girl, a lead singer is the girl.
And so I think, which is what we did. I never, because I always had to turn my phone on, get it up, and make a comment. So unless there's somebody like, I met a few on the Monkey Man, different things he said. Adam Amsoil, I usually comment on his. I usually comment on, there's another one. Oh, Adam Sandoval, I've commented a couple times on his. Well, see, I'm like that. I don't know how many of you are like that. Now, she goes through all these comments and she's reading every one of them. And see, I'm that way, that if I go on, just like the Monkey Man, if I go on his live or something, or anybody's live, and I make a couple of comments about what they're talking about, I'm not making anything up. And if they don't comment back within about 15 minutes, I'm gone. I leave. I just figure, you know, if they're that busy and they're just shooting the shit and they're not interested in what, you know, coming through. Now, some people are just saying hi, and, you know, you can just do the hi to them. You don't necessarily have to acknowledge everybody. But I think that's why that's one of the reasons we don't get a lot of cash on these chats, where you do it, you see it on these other people, because they're not commenting for you. They're not answering your comment. But if you give them money, they're going to, of course, hey, you gave me $20. Hi, George. Appreciate you being on here tonight, you know. And so we don't do,
I think he said,
we talk to everybody.
Marcus said it was like a $599 value.
Yeah, $599 value.
So that's what it was, $599 value.
So basically, I don't know if you figured that, it'd be $600. It'd be $1,200 if you were there for the whole rally. But for what you're getting, you're not just getting a tent. You're getting some entertainment. You got hot tubs out there. They got mimosas, and they got all these different kinds of drinks. Now, in Sturgis, they can't do the alcohol because Buffalo Chip does it. But they have all kinds of different things, and he didn't say it, but sometimes they actually cook breakfast, and they've done things like that in the past for their guests. He doesn't advertise that because in case they don't do it, they're busy and things like that. But they have games going on, and it's kind of like a compound. And we're gonna find out more when we go to Leesburg.
That much.
What?
Emory says he's just there making snow angels. I said didn't look like he got that much. It just looked like a dusting. But he said that was early morning. He might have got more snow than that. Mm-hmm. Red King says, do people usually ride to Tampa, hang out during bike week, like one day?
Not that I know of. I don't know anybody that I've ever talked to here. Not saying nobody has not done that, but more people would be more likely to go down to the Keys and back, I think, than go. Palomoto might be a good guy to ask because he rides all over the place.
Yeah.
You know, do you?
You do fine acknowledging us. I try to.
And so the idea, well, just like the comments, and we were taught this when we first started our YouTube channel, is, which I said this last night too, and you should think about it when you're watching other people's videos. If you watch a video and you've watched the whole video, like let's say you watched the video we had this morning, which wasn't real long, and you decided, hey, I'm going to write a question. Somebody said it today. Oh, you're too rough on Tam. You know, she probably could, if she said everything you did wrong, it'd be a really big list. And I wrote back and said, probably, or really, or I wrote something down. But I didn't read it all, and I did it. Well, if I just blew it off and said, you know, just a happy face or a thumbs up, and I didn't type anything, I didn't spend time typing. And that's what somebody told us that taught us how to start doing YouTube was, if somebody's going to spend the time, 6 minutes, 8 minutes, 15 minutes, and watch all your video and make a comment, and if you don't have time to respond to them, what does that say to you? So that's one of the reasons we comment. Now, I'm not saying there's not any other people out here that don't do that. Now, I'm not real good on Facebook. My thing is YouTube. So on Facebook, we don't always comment back on our comments just in normal Facebook. Now, if you're coming up here on Facebook, she's commenting now to you. But if I put a post up today and it says, whatever it is, well, our big one, it's got 35,000 or 36,000 subscribers on it for Sturgis. I don't comment on those, most of those things, and which I should, but there's no way I could ever keep up with that. I would never be able to keep up with my YouTube. So my YouTube is my main bread and butter that I do all my work.
Is that Mike?
There's a bunch of people.
Your moderator? Okay.
Yeah, I got a bunch of people. I got Rider like six
X,
or eight
this
people.
Is really nice. Rider X says, if Marcus would give you a reduced rate and someone else would go in with me, he would be willing to contribute for that guy that really wants to come.
I don't know if it would not.
I don't know. We'd have to talk to Marcus. Oh, and he wrote me too. He wanted to know. He says he hasn't heard nothing yet. Michael, the guy that won, he said he didn't know if he should have heard something by now. I'll call Marcus when we get done. If you're on, Michael. Palmotto is Last Chance Saloon, still in Florida City. I don't know. He's asking him, I guess. The major hotel's in decent shape. I think out there where the canteen is at.
Oh.
Are the major hotels in decent shape during, from the hurricane? Most of them. And we did go by that Hawaiian resort last night, and people are in it. Cars in the parking lot. Bob kind of looked inside, went inside. He said there's like an inch of dust everywhere. So I called and I said, hey, can I get a room for Daytona Bike Week? And they said I couldn't get it for the whole time, but I could get it from the 5th through the 10th. And it was going to be like almost $1,400, $1,398 with tax and everything. And I said, okay. And then, so that's what Bob said. He wants to call the city on Monday and see if the city gave him an official okay to open. Somebody said, we watched a couple of videos on it this morning or last night. I don't know when it was. It must have been this morning. And they said that all they had to do was fix the seawall. That I guess the building structure itself, I guess, was okay. But they had to support the seawall. And Bob said when he went back there, there's these gigantic sandbags that are all up, I guess, against the building. So I guess it's okay to be open. Mavericks was another one that we saw that was closed. And when we went by it last night, it still had the caution tape up, but there was a lot of cars in the parking lot and all the lights inside were on. So they must be trying to get ready for Bike Week too. And then we didn't go back. The other one that was all closed down was Pirates Cove, and that's down off the lot, Dunlawton, down that way. I don't know if that one's up or not. Did you? Oh, geez, you got a Coke?
That was the only choice.
So they were asking if there was any hotels that were damaged from the hurricane, and I told them about the Hawaiian resort. So
we don't know about that. Yeah, we're going to call Monday and see what the story is. Now, somebody else did a video the other day, and I kind of watched that, and they said the main issue was that they had to shore up where the flood wall was at, and they did that with the bags. So, but the sign on the door said it was condemned, and they had to have an engineer look at it. So we don't know. Magically, it opened up sometime this week. I don't know when, after the rally, after Saturday.
Tuesday, Wednesday.
So somebody came on that comment and wrote, hey, I just called and they said they're back open. It is nasty in there. The windows had dirt all over them. They didn't clean them. There's some, looks like a biker dude at the front counter.
He said he had long, scraggly hair.
And it was like, I didn't even go inside. I was going to go inside and ask questions.
No, I thought you said you went in.
No, I said I was going to go in, and I didn't.
Mike Skidmore said her two wheels only replies to her Patreons, nobody else.
And I've heard that before. Somebody else commented that the other day. I seen if you're not giving them money, they don't respond to you. And that's
we love all you guys.
And it's, well, you look at it, well, it makes me think now when I go to somebody's channel. What's he said?
Hey, Michael.
The other day, which Adam Sandoval knows who we are, and normally he always comments on me. If I write something down or he sees us, he even chased us down one time in Sturgis last year because we didn't even see him. And he stuck his camera up and said, oh, look, it's Bob and Cam. Hey, guys, how's it going? You know, and he talked a few seconds and he was walking down Main Street in Sturgis. And I was like, oh, that's pretty nice. He threw us on camera and he's done it before. And so he was doing the live announcing he was going to do this dealership ride. So I wrote on there and said, oh, man, that's really great, Adam. It's always great to go back and do what made your channel great. Which that's what started. That's how we started watching Adam, or I did. Started watching Adam because he was doing all those veteran rides and going around the dealerships and stuff. And that's how we met him the first time. So it was kind of neat. And I just giving him a compliment. He didn't say nothing. So then a little bit longer, I wrote something else. And I don't remember what the second comment was. And then, you know, 5 or 10 minutes later, 5 minutes, whatever it was, he was on a live. And I wrote another comment. So I put three comments down within about a 15-minute time, never acknowledged any of them. And I gave him a thumbs up, you know, behind him to give attention. You can also do a at and put their name in, and it'll actually highlight it. Some of you might know that, some of you may not. That kind of brings it out. But he never even said, hi, Bob and Tam. The Monkey Man's been doing it. If I get on his channel, he'll say, hey, bye, there's Bob and Tam. And then the Mrs. Monk gets on and she says something to us and stuff. So it's, you know, I don't expect somebody to do it all the time because it's like sometimes when you're looking like the Monkey Man, he's already off just talking about something. And then she's kind of looking at stuff once in a while. And then she'll talk about something. And then he kind of looks, because sometimes I'm like, I don't know who they're talking to. And I have to go way back in the comments. And I'm like, geez, they're like 40 comments behind. And then so if you're and then I think all they do is just kind of thumb it up and then they get where they're at now. And then they get another one. So they don't see. You know, maybe they go back and read them all. I don't know. I don't go back and look at any of this stuff. Once you've made it, on a live. If once you've made a comment here, I don't come back and look at this.
Sometimes at the very end, if a few of you say goodbye or ask a question, we'll try to respond. I don't know if it comes back up or not. New England Biker said their swimming pool somewhere in the Atlantic right now, right? They lost their whole back end.
The pool is actually, I seen this guy's video the other day, which I guess I only went around it's a horseshoe hotel. And so there's two arms on it that come out closer to the water. And that's the only part that I seen. I didn't know it was horseshoe. So I watched this guy's video today. The whole back of the pool is completely exposed. They're going to have to, I don't know if that pool will never be able to open again. Because if they try to pack it back up and turn it on, that pool's going to crack. So they're going to have to, there's going to be a long time before they get a pool put back in that place.
Well, you said they were supposed to have an inside one too, didn't
they? I don't know. There's still water in that. Whoever called said the pools were both out of commission. Because I'm figuring the pool. But I just can't believe they had an engineer look at the property. If, you know, maybe they did, maybe they didn't. So we're going to call. We tried to look in the paper and stuff. And the only thing that was that it had been condemned. And they had videos on it that they locked the doors and closed it. But there was nothing saying that it reopened. So they might have reopened on their own. I don't know. Or maybe they
who put the chain on the door. Maybe they had a key to it.
Maybe they didn't need to have a building inspector, engineer look at the building. Maybe it was just the back wall, and that's maybe they just have a normal warning that they stick on a wall. But there was no normally where we're from, states we've lived in, if a building like that was condemned, it has to have an occupancy permit now on the front door or in the window that says we are now officially open. And here's John Henry, the mayor, whoever signs the damn thing, signs it. So you know that it's safe now. There was nothing on the windows, nothing. So that was very suspicious too. So I don't know. But we're going to check into it on Monday. We're going to call the city and find out who
gave the okay.
If they give a hard time about it, we're going to call the newspaper and say, hey, you know, that building was condemned down there. Is there anything, you know anything about it? Let them go down and investigate it.
Let's say last week it was condemned because we went looked at it. It still had that up there. So I don't know. So Daytona Dave says he'll be seeing us this week. Did you get your tile done? you're going to make the Terminator come out.
So we're probably not. Oh, we're supposed to go tomorrow morning too and talk to Leslie.
Oh, yeah.
That's at 8 o'clock. We won't be eating it, though. We don't have time.
Who's your biggest fan?
I don't know.
Palmoto is asking.
He's
part of the fam.
Yeah. It's but see, we have a lot of our regular, a lot of the people that started with us is the ones that we remember the most because we've seen them the most. And then we've had other people like Rider X. Rider X started watching us probably about a year or more ago. But I mean, before
might
that,
have been before. I don't know.
I don't think it was before. But a lot of you came on here, and now we have some original people. You know, if you ever see Skippy Jones, he's an older gentleman that lives up north, and he's been watching us since day one.
Yeah.
We probably have about, I don't know, 50 people that we know their names, never met them. Is it Beaver?
Bender.
I always want to call him Beaver. Bender's been a guy that's been with us from day one. You'll see him every now and then. We actually met him last year in Sturgis. Very unique guy.
Yeah.
But everybody, it's just neat. It's we've never met. We have never met a subscriber yet.
Better late than never.
That we regretted meeting anybody.
Billy's on there. There you go.
And when you guys hit in town?
In 1 hour from Daytona. Lots changing on Main Street. Not going to be the same next year.
Nope. That's what we're hearing, too. We heard that
Dirty
Harry's only got a end-of-the-year contract. That's it. But what we're hearing is ends up being it's the LPGA that bought the property, which is a stupid – well, here's what really happened.
We got some scoop. It's hearsay. So.
Well, I kind of believe this now.
Take it with a grain of salt.
So what happened is about 5 to 10 years ago, the LPGA was looking to buy property as an investment to sell.
Yes.
You'll buy it, have it a few years. They knew floor is getting hot because all the people moving down here. So they thought, you know, hey, we'd like to buy some property. Well, they knew the lady that owns, which we're not going to say her name. She owned all that property. And so she said, yeah, for $5 million, you could buy all my property.
Well, all that on Main Street.
Yeah.
She owns a lot of the property.
Oh, yeah. She owns half of Daytona. And so they said, oh, okay, can you write that up for us? And she's like, yeah, I'll write an agreement up for you. Well, she hadn't heard from him in 5 or 10 years. And all of a sudden, at the end of the year last year, they walked up to her and said, we'd like to buy the property now. And she's like, oh, what would you like to offer me? He said, this deal. Well, I don't know if she didn't sign it and put a date on it, that it was only good for 60 days, 90 days. But she ended up selling. The property should have sold for over $10 million, and she got five. Lady's very wealthy. She's got a lot of money. But the Hog Heaven, which is out front, which we didn't know, the original Dirty Harry, her grandpa, actually opened that barbecue stand 41 years ago, probably 42 years ago, opened it up, and he ran the barbecue stand. I had no idea that that was Harry that had that barbecue stand. So now what we heard about that was that a new owner bought the barbecue stand, and they signed a lengthy lease with it that could not be broken by a new owner. So they're pretty well set now, and it looks like that's not going to change. We had great barbecue the other day there. Best in Florida so far. And so we went there. So then we heard Dirty Harry's and stuff, the bank and the lot over there, that she wants out. She's, after this year, she's done. If somebody wants to buy the bars and reopen them, she's up for sale right now. If you want to get up by her business, you might want to contact her and buy it. If not, it might be empty building sitting there after Biketoberfest. That sounds like what's going to happen. We're now hearing, nothing from the city looking to do anything in there. What the rumor is, this has been going on for a while. Main Street's dead. If it wasn't for Biketoberfest and Bike Week, there's nothing going on down there. The freaking kids that are 16, 17 years old ain't got no money to spend down there anyway. So all they're doing is walking up and down the street, and they're not doing anything. They're not even walking down Main Street. They're out there on the A1A walking up and down. So there's nobody spending any money down there. So half the businesses are closed. We were down there a week before the rally, Bike Week here, and you go to the bars down there, and there's like five people sitting in the bars.
Probably just locals.
And so they're not making any money.
That's what they said. They don't know if it'll be any different. If people are just there hanging out, the people will still think it's there. So, and then Mon, yes, the Black Hills Harley is still going to be open. And are you coming to Sturgis again this year? I think she said she was going to. She's the one that gave me my koala bear that's on the bed. I heard it was the same. But technically, it isn't official. Yeah, so that's
the word. We'll know after Biketoberfest. Yeah. If the doors get locked, you'll know she ain't coming back. She ain't opening them up no more.
They're talking about Black Hills Harley.
Oh, Black Hills Harley, we already know all that. That sold. Black Hills Harley finalized about 2 weeks ago. They called us on the phone 2 days after it sold and said, we sold. Nothing right now. Everybody, well, there was four owners at one time that owned Harley Davidson over these last 20 something years. Four guys bought it. One guy dropped out a couple years ago, and it was just three guys. Well, the only guy we ever talked to was Al. He's been on our channel a couple of times over the last couple of years, and we got sat down with him when we went back in October and talked to Al. He is the last one still there that was a previous owner. He has signed a four-year contract with the Sonic Group, which is who bought Black Hills Harley, to stay on board. At this moment, nobody's getting terminated. They're adding more people. What's going to end up happening from what we hear from them is Sonic Group has bought other Harley Davidson dealers that don't run so smooth as Black Hills Harley does. Black Hills Harley still sells bikes, even in snow like this. They sold a couple bikes last week. You don't think that, hey, there's 20 inches of snow on the ground, but they sold a bike and guy had it out front and took a picture of me. So they are selling bikes year-round out there. It's just not during Sturgis. So they are doing stuff. So they're actually going to be sending some of their key people around to some of their other stores, non-rally time, to help their other stores get up to the level that Black Hills Harley is. Overall, Black Hills Harley has one of the best star recommendations on service, parts,
motor clothes,
and selling bikes. They're not number one in any of those, but they're number one in all that overall. Together. Yeah, overall, which is a great thing to say. And same thing, we've never seen anybody in there get really bad service and stuff. But I mean, sometimes things don't always go right. And that's one of the reasons we guarantee things. Art had problems, almost 20 years ago when he was out there and we were with him and had some issues with, but it could have been the service advisor. They were trying not to cover his extended warranty on something. And it was just, they ended up doing it, but it was an argument to get it done. That's where we did this. And so things do happen out there on the road. And
you call me because I'll forget. Writer X, when's us to call him?
Call as soon as we get off, because we're going back to the trailer, probably.
Don't think we'll have much service there?
No, I said you can call back.
Oh. Lynn, which Harley dealer gives you the best price?
Well, there's several dealers that will sell at manufacturer's price. That's me. I prefer...
And dealers, so, to start there.
So what I do is, if I'm looking to buy a bike, first thing I'm going to do is what they call homework. You're going to start doing some checking to figure out what it's worth. Now, don't go to eBay and look at what people are selling stuff on eBay. Now, there is a trick that you can go in there and you can hit the that you want to watch it. And then after it sells, you can see what it sold for. Gives you an idea. But when you're looking at something like that, you're not sure. Good place to go is the Cycle Trader and things like that. And call some of the people up that are selling the bikes and kind of feel them out. You can also go online and look up NADA and some of the other ones out there that actually what the dealers use. And most of the time, they're looking at trade-in. Now, anything that's been done to somebody's bike has got no value.
No.
It's only if you're stupid enough to pay more for it because you want that, that's you. But if you were bringing it here to the dealer, they're not going to give you any more money for it. So when you're looking at a bike, if I was looking at a used bike, which we've been screwed before because I ended up impulsing buying stuff without doing my homework.
Well, we went to buy one bike and ended up buying a different bike.
And I paid too much for it. And
that
so
was my Fat Boy Low.
So now I, which I always do on anything, I always check prices just because they got a sticker on here that says this bike is, let me go look at the bike behind us here.
So yes, Rod, there's a bunch of cool bands coming to the Buffalo Chip. George Thorogood, REO Speedwagon, Styx, Whiskey Myers, and they're going to announce another one on the 28th. I think there was another one, but I can't remember who it is. I don't know, but okay. I like them all so far.
Okay, so sitting behind us here is kind of, I don't know if that's gold or what color that is. Let me show you the bike.
I don't like it.
Whoops. Okay, so that bike there, which is a touring bike, it's a ultra classic. Now, what they're doing right now here, which I've seen a couple other people doing this, you get a lifetime warranty on the bike. It means you aren't going to really spend anything but oil changes on it. So, kind of nice. Every bike that they're selling new here has already got that in the price. So, this bike here, brand new, it's fully dressed. I don't see anything extra done to this bike. They're asking $37,000 for it. So, what you'd have to do here is go to Harley Davidson. Let's go to Harley Davidson and see.
There's some dealers we prefer, but they're mostly out on that.
Well, there's a lot of people. There's a guy in Vermont. We recommend
Wilkins.
Wilkins. Excellent dealer. I would recommend them. Adamac. We've never bought anything from them, but we've seen how they... you can tell them how we find people.
He listens to the sales pitches and sees what they do. But that's what the first thing we start at is we look at if they sell their bikes at MSRP. And then how they treat their customers. Nothing high pressure. You want to make sure somebody's going to sit down and show you all the numbers. What this is what you're paying for the bike. This is what the extended warranty is. This is, you know, you want to do all that. You can get the extended warranty online for $695. That's what it was a few years ago. So you can buy that. You don't have to buy it through the dealer because anything over that $695 or whatever it is now, that's dealer's money in their pocket. So they want to get as much for it as they can. So stuff like that. And we did a video a couple years ago on it. I think it was how to buy a trailer because so many trailer places were screwing people. And so we went through and said, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this. Look for this, look for this, look for this. So kind of the same way you can apply that to anything, buying a car, buying a house, buying a motorcycle, you know, one, do your homework. So you know that what you're going to pay is fair market, that you're not going to pay an exorbitant amount, and if it happens to be a little bit cheaper, then hey, you're better off that way too. And then you want to, you know, look on the website and see what their reviews are, if they've got good or bad reviews on their sales, on their service, things like that, and to make sure that they're going to take care of you once you buy the bike, unless you're out on the road somewhere and buying a bike.
So we look at this bike that was just back here, and I don't see anything special on it. So this bike right here, and there's seven different colors available for, that's a road glide.
Street glide special, what is it?
It's a ultra, CV then says in the CV, ultra, still about the same price. No, it's a tour pack. So here we are. It's really about the same price. So almost $30,000. $29,799 is what manufacturer's list price is on that touring bike. So they're asking $37,000 for it. You might go, wow, that's a really big upgrade or up in the price. Well, they are giving you a lifetime, which I'd want to go into the warranty and see what, if it's unconditional warranty and they're going to, you know, I don't know if they're doing brake pads and all that kind of stuff. But if you know, if I know I can keep this bike and I lived here in Florida and I never have to worry about putting valves in it or lifters or a chain or any mechanical stuff to it, $7,000 would be well worth it. Extended warranty just for 5 more years is usually $2,000 and up. So you're getting, you know, for $5,000 more, I don't know what the warranty, extended warranty is now we're going for. They're probably more, they're probably $2,500 or $3,000 now compared to what we bought, you know, in 2014. So say it's $3,000 now for extended warranty. You know, maybe he's bought extended warranty lately. So you got 5 years, that's 7 years altogether on the bike if you buy an extended warranty. So you'd already pay $3,000 more, which would bring you to $33,000. So here they're giving you an unlimited, it says unlimited lifetime warranty. So just have to ask the questions. But for 37,
probably as long as you own the bike.
Well, yeah, you probably, but it may be transferable. I don't know. You have to come in and ask. We'll have to ask how it works. And
Rex says the one question nobody ever asks is the buyback rate. You guys know what that is.
Well, you can't go by that. That's on anything you buy nowadays. If you bought a computer, there's a buyback rate. And you know, it's not like I used to sell toolboxes when I used to sell Mac tools. I would give you back what, as long as you upgraded, I would give you back what you paid for it. Now, some dealers might do that. If you came in here and bought a $20,000 bike and you had it for a year and said, hey, I want the CVO that's $50,000 now, will you give me back what I paid a year ago for my bike? They might do that. You know, I don't know. But most places don't have a buyback because everything Harley's depreciating a lot more now than they used to. But no matter what they say, a Harley still holds their value a lot better than an Indian or a Honda, anything like that. They don't hold the value that the other ones do. More people will, everybody's looking for a good used
buyback
bike.
Rate is the number of points the finance company marks up to the loan. Yeah, if you do that, if you keep telling them, no, that's not good enough, they'll keep coming down because that's what they do. If you go through Harley Financing says, we'll finance them for 8%. And they'll come back and they say, okay, we got 15% interest. And we're like, no, that's way too high. All right, let's go see what we can do. We can do it for 12 because that percent in between the 8 and the 12, that goes in their pocket.
Well, the first thing I always tell people, and that's these high-pressure dealers that we know, if you walk in the front door and you're looking at a bike and the first thing they ask you is, what can you make a monthly payment at? That's your sign to turn around
and walk out.
Because they're only, then they're going to get you. You say, well, I can afford $450 payment. Okay. They're going to find whatever they can jam into it to get you up to $450. Maybe, and that's the problem. When you start buying the extended warranties, you start, just like this bike. So if you bought this bike for $7,000 more than it listed for, you just lost $7,000. So if you sold it right tomorrow after you drove it off the lot, they're only going to give you, less than $30,000 for it because it's now a used bike, but you'd have to look at the NADA and see what it is. But that's what people don't always realize when you buy stuff. That's why you should always put money down. You shouldn't finance stuff with no money down. But if you're going to put accessories on your bike, let's say, hey, I'm going to buy this $37,000 bike. Hey, while we're here, let's go ahead and do a stage 4 on it. You know, because that way the warranty is going to cover it while I have it. I have that lifetime warranty on. Oh, by the way, let's go ahead and do this. And let's put some air shocks on. Let's put this on. Let's go. Next thing you know, you spent $20,000, $25,000 more on the bike.
Now you're upside down.
Now you got a $50,000 bike that's really only worth $30,000. You haven't even pulled it off the lot yet. Well, you got what you wanted. But if you keep the bike for a lifetime, then that's great. But if you're making payments on it, you're going to pay $100,000 for that bike when you get done. You got to think about that. If you're buying this bike for $37,000, and let's say you put $3,700 down. That's your down payment. You're going to pay pretty close to about six. If you finance it for the whole time, you're going to be somewhere between $50,000 and $60,000 that you paid for that bike. That's the price of financing things.
Another thing that we recommend is before you figure out what you want, what bike, just go shopping and say, I like this bike. I like the way it feels. This is what I want. Then go home, do your homework, figure out how much you want for it. If you have a credit union, don't go to the bank, go to a credit union, say, this is the bike I'm looking at. What would you finance me for? So if you're...
They won't tell you what the loan... They won't tell you what... They'll tell you what the loan value is. And that's what you want to know. We now finance everything through credit unions. We've used Harley before. And that's the other bad thing we found out. I bought my 2014, which I knew I could get 2 to 3% on the motorcycle. And this is back in 2014. That I could have got on my new Harley, buying it and financing it through my credit union at work. So we're like, okay, we'll just go through Harley while we're here. And we took it down and said, oh, let me ask you a question about the extended warranty.
Dave?
So that lifetime warranty, is there any exceptions to it?
Well, you have to follow the maintenance of the Harley Davidson.
Do you have to bring it to a dealer?
Right, and it's good at any Harley Davidson or any dealer who's certified by Harley Davidson.
Okay.
And that's for the powertrain is the engine and the transmission. It's for life for you, and if it's transferred, then
it's over.
Right. It's over.
Okay. And so you, and so in a case like that with a lifetime warranty, I don't need an extended warranty.
Well, if you want to extend warranty on electronics and some other things.
Okay.
So you're getting a 2-year unlimited.
Yep.
And then.
This one's mainly the motor and the transmission.
Drivetrain.
Okay.
Everything in the drivetrain. Okay. Which is
yeah.
A big deal.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody coming in here is going, what?
Wow.
Or they bought a bike a year ago somewhere, and they're going, oh my God, I wish I had waited. That's a big deal. And it's not where. When I first came here to work a few weeks ago, I went, well, what does that mean? I have to drive all the way back from New York to get it fixed? No. Any Harley dealership or any dealership.
So the extent, so the lifetime warranty, is that through Harley Davidson then?
It's not through Harley Davidson.
Okay.
It's through a company.
Okay.
But it's a company that's certified through Harley Davidson.
Okay.
So any Harley Davidson dealership or any dealership that's certified to fix bikes by Harley Davidson.
And what's if you have
or the company that's the warranty.
What's the roundabout figure now? Let's say I bought this bike.
Yep.
Got the lifetime warranty on.
Yep.
And I want to get the extended warranty to cover the wiring and stuff.
Yep.
What is that running now?
It depends,
just a ballpark.
I don't know, but it depends on how many years it's going to be. It depends on if you just want it for that. If you want the
tires
maintenance,
and
you
all
want
that.
The tires. So that's all something that finance does away from the sales.
The normal sale. Okay. I was just curious. Back in 2014, I paid $2,000 back then for the tires and for the extended warranty for
right.
5 years.
Right.
So you got a total of 7.
Right.
With it. So we were just talking about it. I'm like, I'm thinking now it's probably at least $3,000.
Probably got to be around that. Yeah. I'm not
and
quite sure.
It definitely went up from 2014.
Yes.
So if you buy the bike and you put a stage 4 on it, is that still covered?
As long as it's done by us. As long as it's done through.
So you still would have the lifetime warranty on that stage 4 engine through here. Through,
well, yeah,
if
right.
I had it done
through here. Through here.
Yeah, through here.
Okay.
Through Harley.
Okay. Yep. All right. So there you go.
We just kind of, we were discussing prices of bikes.
so there you go.
So you got a good idea.
So Palmotto says amazing warranty.
Yeah. And we actually have, if you.
Success Tallahassee and Gainesville has the same warranty.
Now, we also know one that's better than that. There's one in
Red Rock.
Red Rock, Harley Davidson in Las Vegas. And they cover all high performance parts, even parts that Harley Davidson does not install. As long as it's all, like if the dealer sets it all up and let's say you want a tuner on it, you want all this stuff put on it. Now, I don't know what the way the laws are changing, but when we were there last year, their extended warranty covered all performance stuff that you put on your bike, the pipes, everything. So I have no idea what that cost. Probably about 10 grand to have a warranty like that. But when you start thinking about just like my bike, I got done. I paid $1,600 to fix the bearings in it. I put, $3,500 into the engine already. And I might still end up with the 110 being a sucky engine. I still might end up putting an engine in anytime between now and somewhere in the future, another $6,000 or $7,000 into the bike. So that would be the idea. If you're thinking about getting like me, when I bought my CVO, that is really the intention. I had no intentions of ever getting rid of that bike. That was my goal.
That's
and when I
me.
Retired, I took my money out of my 401 and I paid it off because I didn't want, what we looked at when we retired was, if you look at it, my 401 plan, I was only getting about 6 to 8% on it. Well, anything that you're paying more than what your retirement money's bringing in, you're losing money. You're better off
to pay that off.
Pay that off and then pay yourself back, or just like this, get a little job where you can put all that money into your 401 and you can build it back up. And so there's ways to do that once you get to a certain age and you can put more and more money in it. And we also have a health savings account too that we put money into. But so there's ways to do it. But why, if you're paying 10 or 11% on a loan, pay it off. All of our credit cards are paid off. The only thing we still own, the truck's paid off. The only thing we still own is the mobile, the RV that we have and the house. That's it. My garage and all that, that's all paid for. We don't have a lot of money left over, but we're debt free. We're pretty much, we could sell the trailer. Even in today's bad market, I could get what we owe on it. But I got a lot more. I get what I want. Truck, I can make killer money on my truck because it's paid off. Motorcycle, we just found one a while ago, a 2014 over the Indian dealer. CDO, same amount, and it's nice looking for $18,000. I was like, oh my God. I don't know if anything was done to it. It's got the 110 on it. And it's a nice looking bike.
Silver and like a burnt orange on the bottom.
And for $18,000, it's a good price.
So anyway, that's our pointers on buying a bike or whatever you're going to buy.
Well, this works on anything. If you're buying a car, you're buying a refrigerator.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if you finished your story. Anyway, we went through the Harley Finance when he bought his 14 CVO, went back to the credit union and said, okay, I want to finance it. And they said, okay. And then they came back.
Where are you going to buy it from? And we're like, well, we're getting it out here at
Henderson,
Harley Davidson is where we're getting it at. Okay. Is that where we send the check to? I said, no. I got a loan through them. I'm going to pay it off.
They haven't made a payment. We've only had the bike less than a week.
It's a used bike. Can't finance it then.
They wouldn't finance it.
All they would do
2%.
Is they'd give me 1% less than what Harley was charging me.
For a brand new bike.
Yeah.
And it wasn't brand new because the title had already been switched from Harley Davidson Corporation to his name.
Which I think was crap. But that's from then on, we figured out that when I bought the trailer, they handed me a check from the credit union. When we drove up there, we handed the guy that we bought the trailer, handed him the check. So what ends up happening, especially if you're buying something used, that's really the best thing a credit union. The one we use, one of the big ones we use is out of Utah. It's called American First American Credit Union out of Utah.
America
there's a
first.
Couple, there's a couple other ones. You look
it's
for
America
one.
First.
Look for it in Utah because there's a couple different ones that aren't in Utah. That's their home office. Now we just called somebody here in Florida and they don't do Florida. But if you're buying something, they probably would. He was wanting to buy a house and they won't do a house here. But every time we bought something used, like the trailer, it was 1 year old. They're like, what's wrong with it? I'm like,
Our boat, they did the same thing.
They came up with the craziest money. Our boat was the same thing. I bought his boat for $20,000 a pontoon boat. And they came up and said it was worth like $35,000. They said, has it been wrecked? Is it salvaged? Is it, I'm like, no.
Said the same thing with the trailer.
And And we're like, no, it's brand new. I get really good. I do my homework before. If I'm looking to buy something and we know we're looking to buy it, I am very thrifty buyer. And just like I'm looking for a lift for the shop. We don't have the money right now to buy one, but we are looking around for one. And a lift for the shop.
We're hoping to find one of our vendors that maybe are looking to upgrade to a new one. And they will give us a good deal on one of their older ones. That they're
give it to us for free.
free ride, 365. Yep. Is there such a thing? He wants to know if anybody knows of a reputable and reasonable Toyota dealership.
Check with the Sonic Group or Ed Morris and see if they've got a dealership and see if we can get something. We'll talk to Teddy next week. Oh, I'll tell you that. Next, is it Wednesday? Thursday.
Well, something else is going on. Thursday, because the chopper show is going on.
Teddy Morris is going to have the first official bikini contest, the Teddy Morris.
Miss Teddy Morris.
Bikini contest right here on Thursday afternoon in the pavilion. And funny thing is Teddy is his wife and his kids are all coming down and they're going home on Wednesday. What's with that, Teddy?
I think he's supposed to be one of the judges, too. So we're told. I don't know for sure or not. But
so hopefully we're going to be here to check that out. Hopefully I might have to drop her off and then go back to Tropical Show and stay there and get my shots. And she could do the Bikini Girls. Got to get some stuff for Patreon people to watch.
Yep. Prefer to buy from an individual.
See, you get screwed by an individual,
too.
But see, the bad thing about an individual is, one, you got to watch because they got to have the bike paid off. They ain't got a title in their hand. And we've known some people that have gotten screwed that way too. But hey, I'm gonna go buy this bike. This guy's had it for a year and he's got this ultra touring. It's a $30,000 bike and he's selling for $20,000. He's only had it a year. That's a great deal. What do I got to do? Oh, bud, give me $20,000 and I'll give you the bike. Okay, so you hand him the check and he's like, he gives you a bill of sale. Well, I gotta pay the bike off first and I'll get you the title. We know some people that have gone out of state and bought RVs I don't know if they've still got their title, because what ends up happening is you're no, like, let's say you're buying it from Delaware. Okay. So you live in Ohio. So you're thinking, okay, I'll get the title from that guy, and you're waiting. You gave the guy the $20,000 for what you bought, and you're waiting, and nothing happens. You call the guy, no phone number now. It's disconnected. Or he says it's in the mail. You know, I sent all the paperwork and it should be done. And you call Delaware. Delaware's not going to tell you nothing because you're not a resident of Delaware in any state. If you're not the resident, you're not going to get a lot of information there. I don't know if these people that were buying this RV, this was last year. I don't know if they ever got their title. I said, your first mistake, moron, was you should have never bought anything without having the title in your hand. And you also got to watch that, because there's fake titles. There's people that's made copies. There's people that have got a duplicate title. It's not the original one. There's people that have salvage titles that, you know, there's nothing wrong with buying something if you have a salvage title, but you better buy it at half the price.
But, the ninth is when the bikini contest is out here. Miss Teddy Morse. The title first, cash second. Right. Hello. Well, even this happened when I sold my bike, because we sold it.
But we sold
it. Not really a dealership.
Well, what we did is we had a dealership in town that sells boats, and he sells motorcycles.
Used
motorcycles.
Consignment kind of.
And so he put it on consignment, and he's like, okay, I can get you
X amount of dollars.
Yeah. $15,000 out of the bike. And but it's gonna cost you $1,500 for me to sell it. So we're like, okay, if we don't make a payment for 2 months, we'll be pretty close. We'll only lose $500 on the bike. Because we owed like $15,000 on it. So
true.
We gave him all the paperwork. We signed everything. It had Arizona plates on the bike. And we came from California. And then we've had 1 or 2 years of plates on this bike. It's 2014 Street Glide Special. And you sold it in what year?
2008.
Yeah, it was still 1 year 19, left on the warranty. 19. So. And so we were selling it. And so the guy sold it. And gave the guy, you get a drive away. You get a contract and all this. Well, about 3 months later, The guy calls us because we were on the road, and he's like, I need you to come back in and sign paperwork. And we're like, what for? The title was still in California's name.
Arizona said, we don't have a title for
Arizona. Something happened that it never got transferred to Arizona. So we had to file paperwork for California so he could, and which was not a big deal. And luckily this guy had a drive away sticker. So they just kept renewing his sticker for him. So he was able to drive the bike. But if you were doing that from an individual, it's like, because the title was actually in Las Vegas. That's where, in this part, Harley Davidson keeps in the Midwest, or in the West Coast, they have their office in Las Vegas. But you can't go there and pay them and they'll hand you a check. That's where the processing's at. And then in Arizona, we don't get real titles anymore. You get, it's all computerized now. So you don't get it, which I don't like that either. But
yeah,
all of our expensive stuff is, we have South Dakota to put titles on them.
Same day at Chopper Willie's. Yeah, that's. What's the schedule, fam? So that's what he was saying. He
what
might.
What time does it say the bikini contest started?
I don't know. I didn't see. Oh. It just. He wanted to know which Thursday, and then somebody else said there's only one Thursday.
Yeah.
Because it starts one weekend.
It's two Fridays, two Saturdays.
One Thursday.
One Sunday too. It's over on Saturday.
Yeah. What are your thoughts on Harley wheels and tire protection plan? Does it cover the normal wear and tear?
Well, here's what you do. Now we've only had it on her bike and my bike. Never used it on her bike. My bike, I did. I ran over a nail and got a free tire. Cost you $50 for the tire. And
that's like the
extended warranty to renew it or something. I don't know what it is, but it's $50. That was $50 deductible.
Yeah, deductible.
So
that's what it is.
Then what I did was just mysteriously, the front tire ran over a nail. As long as you have three 30 seconds, if I'm not mistaken, of tread still in the center, they have to warranty the tire out. And there's no limit on how many times they warranty the tire out. There's always a $50 deductible. So if you had two tires done, it's going to cost you $100 at one time. Not saying take it like that. So other than that, that's really good. But the only good thing, too, is by having the tire protection, you get the free towing is included. If you have the extended warranty, you don't have the tire protection, they don't pay for the towing. At least they didn't. I don't know if they changed or not, but I'm assuming they probably haven't changed that, the warranty on that. It's just like my CVO, I never, ever used the extended warranty the whole time I had the bike. I never had any mechanical issues with that bike. It never went into a Harley dealer for anything the whole time I had, other than the tires that I had replaced.
Well, the show starts at noon, right?
We
get there about 10:30.
It goes to 4. It's over at 4.
What time does it start?
Well, they start bringing bikes at 9 or 10 o'clock in the morning. So you want to be there as early as possible. You know, you might get there at 8 and they're already bringing bikes.
Yeah.
We're probably going to be there between 8 and 9. Get a place for her to sit, picnic table in the back. And there is, next door, there is some 1%ers that sit there. They don't, they've never caused any problem. We've been there. They do have some undercover cops that walk around and stuff. But
security.
We've never, the last 4 years we've been there, we've never seen any trouble there. And Willie tells them, but they kind of sit on the other side. They talk. We went over and talked to them.
You
before.
Got almost 100 people on.
Holy, Jennifer Jupiter.
98.
And
give us a thumbs
so
up if you're
it's,
on.
It's I like Willie's. We just Willie wants to come stay at our house. Well, he's not gonna stay at our house. He's gonna come out and check out the shop. And which I couldn't hardly believe.
Well, I think he got really excited when he told him that we wanted to start doing bikes for veterans. And he's like, really, really, because he's really into helping the vets. So yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
And
if he
so
came
yeah,
out.
If Willie came out, we put him on a camera. We may be doing.
He might even help us build a bike.
We might be doing some stuff with. Billy Lane, can you believe it? Things might be happening here. Wouldn't that be a killer for old Monkey Man if Billy Lane would go and do something with us?
Hmm. And New England Biker says they always give Mim free tires as long as he owns the bike, not counting the labor.
What kind of bike?
Well, I think he's saying his extended warranty or his maintenance on his tire. Hmm. Is that a Harley or do you have a different kind of bike, New England Biker? It's on my calendar. Nails and tires. One time my brother had parked a bike in our cousin's garage with no lights. And in the AM, we saw the floor was covered with nails. No flats. Amazing. That is amazing.
So that's one of the things that I look at, too, is you never know. And see, that's what kind of sucks about motorcycle tires. You know, if we're racing, it'd be a different story. But if you're driving normal, there's no reason why a motorcycle tire can't be fixed. But you can't. Any hole in a tire, it has to be replaced. I don't know.
He's got a Harley Triglide. That's cool. He's got three tires instead of two.
So I don't get why you can't fix it, but that they don't do it, especially if you got a tube in it. If you can patch, as long as it's just a nail hole in it, put a patch on it and put a tube in it. But I guess that's what they figure is you only got two wheels. And if one of them goes,
you're in trouble.
You know, and you're doing 70 or 80 miles down the road and it blows really good and you lose control and you die. Or if you're in a car, you got four tires. One blows, the odds are you're not going to flip unless you're driving an old CJ75 that likes to flip over with one tire down. But if you're driving a motorcycle, so I guess that's the reasoning. But if I was back to repairing tires, I'd probably put a plug still in it and patch. If I had the equipment and able to do it.
At the new shop, we backed in the trailer and put it in there for a while and ran over a screw because
it was from the builder left him out in the driveway. But we have a road hazard on that. We buy all of our tires on the trucks and the cars, the trailer. We buy everything from Discount Tire because they're one of the only ones that all you pay for is if you have a flat is you have to pay for the new road hazard, which is anywhere from $30 to $50 depending on the dealer. That's it. As long as there's tread on the tire, the tire's not even there anymore. We had one fly off, and all that was left was just the sidewall. The middle of the tire was gone. Well, look, when I came in the other day, and I wasn't even sure the nail had gone through the tire. I hadn't lost no air. And so a guy walked out there and looked at it and said, oh, it's too close to the sidewall. You get a new tire. Okay. Probably was nothing wrong with the tire. Probably could have pulled the screw out. It probably wasn't long enough to go. It was a brand new tire. And we only came from Florida, wherever. There's some old gal riding on a bike. Can't turn the camera around fast enough.
No.
She got some big old, she got some love jugs on her bike. If you know what I'm talking about.
Why does Harley sell plug kits then? Is this correct? Is that correct?
I don't know. Is it got a parts department? I'll go ask.
Fixing the back tire would be safe. Not sure about the front. Oh, my nose itches. I don't know about tire goes flat. I just take it and get it fixed. I don't know. I had my dad before he'd let me drive my car. I had to know how to change a tire and change the oil. And then he finally gave me the keys and said, there you go. I don't know why. Never did it after that. I just couldn't get the keys unless I changed the tire and changed the oil. Take care, guys. Being paged for dinner. All right. Goodbye, New England Biker. Yeah, we've been on almost 2 hours anyway, so we'll probably get off here soon. The Mercy Show. See you guys there on Monday the 6th. Sounds good. We'll see you here when you get here. So we've got a few places we're going to do some meet and greets. Oh, my goodness. My nose itches. We're going to be, oh, my gosh. Where does it start? Friday. Do they have them? No. Guess they don't sell them. Pins.
No plug kits. Maybe years ago, but the guy sitting here said, no, we can't sell plug kits. We can't plug tires in the shop. Why would we plug tire? I said, well, even for an emergency kit. He said, we don't have nothing.
So I was just going to tell him we've got 5-10 minutes left before we've been on 2 hours. Blowout on the front, not nice. No, it would not be good. I have had a couple of flats while riding. Not a good feeling. Nope.
So we've had.
Tell him some what we're going to do, where we're going to be.
Okay. So tomorrow, we're heading up to Adamac up in
Jacksonville,
Florida. So we're going to be riding up there. We'll be there by 11:30 because the sun show is 12, 2, and 4. And we got to come back down here. So we're going to be up there at noon to film that. So we're hoping to get there between 11 and 11:30. So if you're there early, we'll talk to you and stuff like that and check it out. And then we'll film that. And we're going to do a live tomorrow around that time, Eastern time. So somewhere between 12 and 1, we're going to be coming on. So if you want to come back and see what's going on in Adamac, you can check that out. That'll be a live tomorrow. We're not going to be doing a live tomorrow night because we're going to be doing having dinner with somebody. Unless they decide they want to go on the live. And but we end up talking to you guys more than we'll be talking to them. So probably won't happen.
Wouldn't be fair to them.
So that's what we got planned for tomorrow. So that's Sunday. Monday, we're going to go out to Fastlane where they do the burning bike. And we're going to be doing an interview with him before lunch. After lunch, I don't know yet what we're doing.
We still need to do the ride that we were thinking about doing.
We're just going
to
do that tomorrow. And now that the sun show, I don't know what, because there's so much stuff going on. I may not have enough time to get some stunts video to put in videos after the rally's over. So at least we can go up there. And these are supposed to be like professional type guys. I got it. It's on my Facebook page. So we're going to do that on Monday. So
probably go by the Iron Horse too. They said we could come by there.
Oh yeah. So we're probably going to go by the Iron Horse and the Broken Spoke.
I have to call the city to find out about Hawaiian.
Yep. We'll be doing that in the morning. She might do that on the way while we're traveling uptown.
Monday.
And then so Tuesday, don't have a whole lot doing Tuesday. Maybe Tuesday will be the day we go do the ride and see about doing that.
How long it is.
Yeah. The
Ormond Loop.
Yeah, the Ormond Loop and out to the lighthouse. And then after that Wednesday, we're going to be over here at Joey's, which that's, don't really want anybody to come by. He's going to be filming that, and he's doing it for a video for his shop. And that's all we get for your handlebars. Well, the handlebars already bought, but he's going to do labor free for us.
It'll be in the morning for you.
Compensation for that. So that won't be live or anything like that. So I don't know how long. Probably by noon he'll be done, unless we do some other videos for him over there. He's paying us to do some videos for him.
That's Wednesday, right?
Yes. Thursday, we don't really have anything going on. Friday is rally starts. Welcome to the rally. Bike week starts. And so Friday, what are we doing Friday?
We'll be out at the track.
Yeah, we're going to go out to the track. They're saying they're thinking about noon that we should be out at the speedway. So we'll stay out there for a while. I don't know how long. Depends on how exciting it is. We're going to be watching the real racing the next day. So I don't know. We may be there 10 minutes and leave. I don't know. And then we're going to end up probably going to Cackleberry on Friday and staying into the evening to see Confederate Railroad. I believe it's 7 to 8:30 they're coming on. If I'm not mistaken, it's early. And I'm like, wow, that's really great to have a big band like that come on early. And so we're going to go there and hang out over there for a while. I always wanted to spend an evening at Cackleberry, and this might be that one evening we spend, and that's it. So then Saturday is crazy, 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 crazy Saturday. So we had we got like 14 things I need to do on Saturday, but we're narrowing it down. We had one, now we got two. So 9 o'clock in the morning at the Indian dealer. If you'd like to see, or if you got an Indian bike, you can ride in their owner's group. And what's nice about it is the president of Indian Motorcycles is supposed to be there to do a meet and greet. So I'm hoping he's going to get there about 8, and then we can meet him at 8 and get in line, talk to him, get him on camera. Just neat. I'm not an Indian guy, but still be neat to meet
the
president.
Email us your contact information.
And so and there, we'll switch numbers. And then we're going over to Smyrnaw, whatever it is. What's the racetrack?
New Smyrna.
Yeah. We're going there to the racetrack on Saturday. We'll be there around between 11 and 11:30. But if you want to be with us, you have to be in the pits, which costs you $100. And you also get a dinner out of that, too. You get to meet the drivers and have a dinner. These are famous people. If you want to be like the Monkey Man says spend $100 and get him a VIP ticket. He was overwhelmed just meeting Billy Lane. You ain't met nobody yet.
There's
till you
a
see
lot
who else
of guys
is down
out there.
Oh, yeah.
And girls.
Yeah. Perowitz, all kinds of people down there, and the bikes they have, it's going back 100 years of racing, and it's some of the one bikes they race is one cylinders that have no brakes on them, and they do like 90 miles an hour with these things. And it's just a lot of fun. And it's old school racing. And people always say that, oh, I want to see old school racing. I don't really get the views off of this. And I don't know why, because people always say, I want to see some real racing. Well, that is real racing. That's as real as you can get. Most of the bikes are built by Billy Lane. Half the bikes probably out there are Billy Lane creations. I know the one Shelley Rossmeyer rides is a Billy Lane bike. And so she'll be out there on Saturday. So that's where we'll be Saturday. If it gets over early, we may go out to the lane because they have their bike day from 10 in the morning till 6 o'clock in the evening. What a lousy day to have a rally on. You're not even having a freaking all night. Why wouldn't you have it till 10 or 11 o'clock or at least 10?
They don't have any bars out there.
The freaking streets roll up at 5, I guess, and the 6 o'clock gives you an hour to get out of town. I don't know. We've never been to the lane.
What day is the Bob?
So then we go. So we may go out there if we have enough time. If we get there before 6, if it's over by 3, we'll go out there. If it's over by 4, we probably won't go out there. So then we'll come back in town and we probably go down on the main street for Saturday night and see all the action and stuff like that.
Going on Saturday.
We're not too far from Main Street. We're actually staying in Port Orange, so we're on that side of the world. So that's Wednesday. Is that Wednesday? No, we're still on Sunday. So Monday, Sunday, we're also doing the, so Saturday, that was Saturday. So Sunday now, we're going to do the breakfast at the Beaver Bar. That's a meet and greet. If you guys want to come out, we'll be there for a couple hours. Maybe we'll do a live on there too. I don't know. Depends on how many you come, want to talk. We won't do a live, but we'll see how it goes. So we'll be there from about 8 o'clock in the morning till probably 10, unless nobody shows up, and then we'll be out of there after we eat. And so that's that. What else we got planned on Sunday is we've got a meet and greet. What?
The Beaver Bar? Is that what you're saying?
7 o'clock.
Okay.
7:45, we're going to be there. Get there early. We haven't talked to her yet. We're supposed to go there tomorrow. So I don't know if we'll get over there in time or not. That's a long way over there and then all the way back. And so I don't know. Maybe we'll catch up with her later in the week. And
well, she's not coming back till tomorrow. She may not even be there in the morning.
No, they said she'd be there in the morning. She's doing the breakfast.
No.
And I think she does some cooking too or something. I don't know. But
I don't know what they're saying. What day is that pit with the dinner, Bob? I don't know that pit. And then somebody else asked, what day is the Bob? Oh, it's the same guy. ZZ Twin Cam. What day is that pit?
Oh, are you talking about the pit passes? That's Saturday at the Sons of Speeds.
$100.
Yeah, it's $100 for the pit pass. That gets you into the pits and it also gets you a dinner that night with the race bike racers. You get to meet them people, and they're all famous freaking people. Can't believe it. And I didn't realize half the people until after we got home and I did the video. You know, Jody Perowicz was racing there, and we knew her, and her dad was there, and all this stuff. It was kind of neat. And there was a couple other people there. You know, those are ones we knew for sure. We went around and talked to everybody. They were all really nice, and they were all getting ready for the race.
David Allen Cole's cousin.
Yeah. He was in, he did the pace lap.
Yeah.
And that was kind of neat to meet David Allen Cole's nephew or whatever he was, cousin. His last name was Cole.
Cool.
And so it was kind of neat. So that's where we're at. And that's Sunday. And it's out at New Smyrna Racetrack, which is just on the other side. Like if you're going out to the Cabbage Patch or Cackleberry, you go to the stop sign, you just stay straight. It's probably a couple miles down the road. It's not very far. Nope. The road comes to a traffic light and it's right there on your right. Can't miss it. You go around the side and you park there. If you get a regular ticket in the stands, it's $20. $100 gets you into pits. And last year they didn't have the dinner and all that going with it, and it was cheaper to get in the pits, and they're trying to stop as many people from going in the pits. So it's VIP. So that's where we're going to be, because we want to get all our videos and all that, but we'll have time to talk to people, because there's times we're just kind of standing around waiting. But they said the races are going to go back to back to back to back to back. Let's see. It wasn't back to back.
There's not going
to
be any intermission between. Yeah.
There'll probably be an intermission, but it won't. It used to be last year when we went, first year we went, they would race the bikes. They come around, they win, they pull them into the pits, then they bring the next ones out and they line them all up. And then, you know, it's like 15, 20 minutes between each race. Well, they're saying now when the first race takes off, they're lining up the next set of bikes ready to go. You only do a couple of laps. They don't do very many laps. They don't do like 100 laps.
I think they do 3 laps, I think.
But it's really neat. And the old bikes and stuff, you don't really see any wrecks or nothing. I think something happened to one guy.
I don't think he dropped. I think he's sprung a leak, the oil was leaking or something. Yeah,
I think something happened. I don't remember.
His bike just.
But it was on the back side of the track. Couldn't see it. It's kind of like it's not a circle track. It's kind of a little bit of a straightaway. It's kind of like the speedway, but it's a lot smaller. And it's a dirt track. And so it's just a lot of fun. So that's Saturday. And you just go to Sons of Speeds, and you can buy your tickets there ahead of time. That's your best bet. That way they're there when you get there. Ours are already there, and we're ready to go. So then Sunday, we're going to do the breakfast at the Beaver Bar, 7:45. After that, we are going, let's say you don't want to get up that early. We're going to have a meet and greet on Monday from 12 to 2 at the Zero 3D truck, which will be over by, it's in Destination Daytona. It's in the park, well, depending on where they put them at. They were over by Speeds, which was where the RVs got all their trailers at right now, across the road from JMP Cycles. I don't know if they're there or not because they complained last year about being around the truck.
They were in the back.
They were on
right in front of JP Cycles, but as far back away from him as you
could get. Yeah, they didn't like that because they didn't have the front walk in. So I'm not sure where they're going to be. And we'll look, as soon as they put the truck in today or tomorrow or Monday, we'll tell you where those people are at. Joey, that was just here from All About Customs, we are going to be doing a meet and greet at his place one time later on in the week. If you're coming later, we'll let you know. We don't have it all set up. We were supposed to do it Saturday, but all this crap came up in the race and all that. So that's kind of Sunday. I don't know what we're doing in the evening. We're probably going hitting some of the bars and things like that. And we'll let you know. If you watch our Facebook page, we'll try to post where we're at and where we're going after these things we're telling you. So that's
Monday.
We'll
be here in time, Johnny, for the bikini contest here at Harley Davidson. You'll get to see Jackal. You'll be here for Willie's Tropical Tattoo. Trapper show, so you'll be here for a lot of fun. He says he's gonna not get here till Wednesday. He's gonna miss all the fun, he said.
Well, it's awesome. No, we haven't got to the good stuff yet. So Tuesday we're doing the Bells ride. Who are the Bells? The Bells is a women's group, Biker Bells. They are a group of women that raise money for women's causes, bike stuff,
women empowerment.
And which I didn't ever know, they allow guys to ride. So they have always had one in Sturgis for I don't know how many years, for a while. 10 years or more. And there's a lot of famous people. If you're hanging out with the Buffalo Chip with us, you will get to meet Tony, which is one of Rod's daughters. She's going to be one of the people leading. Also, if you know who Brian Clockworks is, his ex-wife, Laura Clockworks, she's actually building, she does bike building. She's got a custom bike that's being built for Sturgis to be given away. She's leading the thing. And there's a whole bunch of, if you go on the Bells, Biker Bells website. If you go to our Facebook page, there's a couple links down. I've got a link to go there. It's only $25, but it's $25 per person. So it's going to cost us $50. And so we're going to be there, but at least it's 7:30 in the morning. You get your little happy butt up a little earlier.
Maybe you can go on it. We only have to pay $25.
And but they're back by noon. So that's nice because you still got the rest of Tuesday to do other things, which is kind of nice. So I'm okay with that, but they're going to have a bunch of stuff going on. They're leaving from Harley Davidson Central at the raceway. So that's where they're going to ride. And then when they come back, they're going to have some events going on there with the women and stuff, probably like Moto Maiden. Some of them will have their stuff there and
Spanaros.
But if you like pretty girls who ride motorcycles, you want to meet some, you want to ride with some, here's a way to do it.
For women.
So it's a way to do it. So we're going to do that.
Hey, Jim.
Wednesday is, we're thinking about doing a ride.
No.
So we'll see if nobody's really said that other than Palomoto said he might want to go on a ride with us, but he won't be here on Wednesday. He won't get here till Thursday.
So email us if you guys want to think about, if you don't have anything to do Wednesday and you want to go on a ride with us, we'll go around the Norman Loop.
We got to go do the ride and see how long it takes us. We were hoping to leave like 9 o'clock in the morning, and we were hoping maybe by noon, 1 o'clock, we would be out by the lighthouse, and we were going to eat at Hidden Treasures. Really cool bar right out there, and it's on the beach. Not on the beach, but it's on the water. Inlet. It's really cool bar. We've been there a bunch of times tonight, and really neat place. They got a giant bird you can feed. When we were there with YouTube, and they always gave us shrimp to feed the bird, and a big old giant one of them, giant white cranes, and he hangs out
there. I think his name is Joey.
And so we were going to do that on Wednesday if people want to do that. Thursday is
Willie's.
All set up for Willie's Tropical Chopper Show. Willie's. Get a shirt yesterday. And the back's cooler than the front.
Chopper time.
He's got a Harley emblem. Probably copywriting. But Willie's a great guy. And all the money that's collected all goes to veterans. And if you guys watch Wim's motorcycle building, he's got a website, he's got a YouTube channel, he's going to be there, so you can meet another YouTuber. He's a really great guy too. He does triumphs. He's built several bikes that he has raffled off for charity that are David Mann. See, I never knew that. I didn't realize that David Mann, that made all those pictures and paintings and stuff, that it was always an Easy Rider magazine. Those were figments of his imagination. He never had any of those bikes.
It was never a motorcycle
that looked like any of those bikes. So there's a lot of people that recreate those bikes. Well, this is a gentleman here, Wims. I can't think what his first name is.
Jared.
Oh, Jared Wim. That's it. And he was working out of his garage. I don't know if he's got a shop now or not. We went and seen him a couple years ago. Great guy. He actually, I think on one of my highlight videos, he came up and he wrote back and said, "Hey, I'll see you guys at Willie's." And he's a great guy. Great YouTube channel. But
teaching his daughter how to build bikes.
Well, yeah, it's kind of neat. It's not so, his daughter's not like some of these other ones that are trying to show you the world by their kids and their wives or whatever they are there. So he's.
Genuine.
Yeah. And so a really great guy. So he's going to be there. He'll probably be giving another bike away for our veterans when he's there. And
or
then
the Forgotten Angels.
Yeah. So he does a lot of stuff with them. And so that's going on. Thursday. I think the Badgers are involved with that too, but I don't know if Badger come. I know the Monkey Man's supposed to come because that magazine or that news cycle source is going to, I think there's giving Willie some money to help put it together, which Willie will end up turning all the money over to charity anyway. So doesn't matter. But so you get to see the Monkey Man too. I don't know how long he'll stay there, but we're going to stay there. I'm going to stay there at least till the awards are given away because Willie told me it was well worth staying till the end. So I'm going off Willie's advice. So I may end up taking her for a few minutes leave and drop her off down here so she
or if
can.
If somebody's there and wants to give me a ride down here.
Yeah. And so she can film this down here with the cleanie. And then I'll come back down here after the chopper show's over. He's got some more. You should see the banner he gave me for the shop.
Willie hooked us up.
Oh, yeah. And he's like, stay to the end. I'll give you a couple more. And I'm like, I'll be there. I'm happy.
All right, Eric says he's friends with Shade Tree Surgeon. I think so, because they all live on that, over in that Tampa area.
Yeah.
So they all hang out, know each other. Yeah. They do a lot of rides and benefits and yeah. stuff over there, too.
And it's pretty neat. I've met, we've seen Shade Tree in California. But I never watched his channel ever. Didn't know who he was. And Art, heard my buddy him. Art knew, he's like, that guy, I know him. I kind of walked by him and he had his girlfriend or whoever it is, daughter, whoever that young girl is that runs around with him was there. And I kind of walked by him and kind of looked at him. And I'm like, you know, I don't really know him. And he looked at me and he's like, I guess he's like, I don't know that guy either. So we never said nothing to him. And Art's like, I can't remember what that guy's name is. Well, when we leave. He's like, oh, I think that guy's Shade something. So I typed it in. And I said, Shade Tree? He's like, yeah, that's the guy. They watch him every once in a while.
He says Shade Tree should be a wrestler. That's yeah. what he looks like. So we're almost done, Roadkill Ron. So we'll come over there if you're still over there listening to music. I don't know where you're at. He's probably in here somewhere.
So,
I get it.
So now you broke your good purse.
Well,
now what are you going to do?
It's been screwed up. It's
actually done it again. We're going to do a video on that.
This is mine. You know, he could care less.
So what we
buy a new one.
What we so we're up to Thursday now. Friday next week. I don't know if we have anything down for Friday and Saturday. Oh, we're doing midget wrestling. I think Friday night is midget wrestling at the doghouse. I have to look at the schedule. I'm pretty sure it's Friday night. And you want to have some fun. They don't charge anything for it unless you want to sit in the front row. You got to pay them.
Get a band.
But they got one of the midget girls. She you got to see her. Got dark black hair. If you'd see her from the neck down, you'd be like, I'll date that girl in a heartbeat. But she's like 2 foot tall. And people were calling her around
probably,
like she was a baby.
Like 35
people
pounds.
Were carrying around like a baby. But it's like, you look at her like, man, you are hot. And then but she's like this tall. And it's like, it's just, she's just, because most midget people kind of look, and they call themselves midgets. And so it was just fine. And they're great people. They have a lot of fun and they get the crowd going. And we got them on video last year and we're going to go down there. That'll be a lot of fun. And so if you're here on Friday, you were going to look and see Doghouse.
Here's your wrestling.
And that's going to be where we're at on Friday. Saturday, I don't think we have anything down. We'll probably hit a couple of the bike shows. We'll be down on Main Street off and on. That's the last Saturday. So we'll be down there off and on. A lot of Saturday, we'll be getting footage down there on Main Street. Well, somewhere along the line, we're going to be eating at Peanut and George's. Saturday nights, Peanut and George's has a podcast. It's live on Main Street or live on Daytona or something like
live
that. And that guy usually puts us on his channel. We put him on our channel. And it's kind of neat. So we might do that.
Of course, they only have up February stuff.
I thought she had the new flyer out. She's looking to see. You got it up anyway.
It's there. That's what came up.
Once you gave me a flyer. Well, how did I know? I might have took a picture of it. Doghouse in Port Orange, Midget Mania.
Micro.
Oh, Micro Mania.
They've got their schedule, but.
Oh, there's Micro Mania. Yeah, you probably just go to Micro.
Yeah, but it's not coming up with nothing either. Doesn't have a list of their schedule.
Micro Mania Wrestling
schedule.
Daytona. Tour dates. They come out. They actually come out where we're at, but they charge.
Just my size. Bumoto says. So we'll see you, Grandpa Dude, when you get down here.
18. What's the day going to be?
What day do you think it is?
Friday.
So the 10th?
March.
March 10th or 11th?
March 9th. Sarasota. I don't know.
10th.
10th is in Aurora Hills. I don't know. Port Orange. Saturday, March 11th.
Yeah.
At the Doghouse. So it's going to be on Saturday night. So that's where you're going to be. Go down the main street afterward, after the wrestling. It's a lot of fun. It's just a lot of fun. But you got to get there early to get close. Get a table or something like that to sit in. But if you want to sit in one of the chairs, you got to pay money. So they sell tickets. I guess it's click for info. They sell front row seats you can buy. I don't know what they are.
If you don't have a wristband on, that guy will kick your butt out.
Yeah, they yelled at her.
The shortest plus
50 shortest plus. 50 plus short sport bike rider. Says Pavamoto is the shortest.
He said that they're his size.
You're not that short. All right, come on. It's not. It's going to open up their Facebook page. They haven't opened up. Bull says, I'd like to have a good reason to go to Sturgis next year so I can go. Hint, hint. What's a good reason to go? There's a good chance that we could have the American Flat Track Racing in Sturgis next year. They're building a track at the Buffalo Chip. Think of the greatest person you'd want to hear in Sturgis on Saturday night, and that band might be coming. He's going to make an announcement. They're still on the fence about getting tickets for the Buffalo Chip. Prices are going up on the 28th. So you get last time is the 27th at 5 p.m. Mountain Time. So if you want to get some passes to come see us, I highly recommend Friday and Saturday, the first weekend. We're going to be having the wedding. We got a whole bunch of activities we're doing on Friday night inside the campground. Saturday is going to be our barbecue. We might have a couple of people, but right now it's Camp Easy Rides that he wanted to sponsor it. But we're going to have Catered by Barbecue. Good best barbecue
in South Dakota.
In South Dakota.
Leave it at that.
Yep. I'll be a member by then. And so it's a really great time. Well, Sturgis is great. There's no bad time in Sturgis. And it's like when anybody ever goes to Sturgis the first time, I don't know, they send me to the doghouse. So
he's just sleeping in the doghouse.
It's like, I don't know. They don't told know. Me to go here to see.
To get tickets? Even on an hour and 20 minutes.
Holy crap.
2 hours and 20 minutes.
I don't know.
We'll find out if you want VIP passes, what it costs.
Yeah. We're going to go down there and stop and talk to her next week, too, because she couldn't talk. She had meningitis. So you got, they had a lot of stuff. The wind's been blowing here and pollen's really high and all that stuff. So there's a lot of people that are coughing and hacking and we're trying to stay away from them. So we're down to 64, way down from 100 we had a while ago.
Yep.
So we're going to go ahead and wrap this one up tonight and we're going to come on tomorrow. We're going to be out in Jacksonville, Florida. We're going to be at Adamac. They're a new dealer. They got, they have one down in
Yeah, one in St. Augustine's, and then they've got a that's on right off the 95, and then they've got one in a t-shirt shop downtown St. Augustine's. So
they only have two dealerships?
I think so.
And they had three dealerships. I don't know. I think they had more.
Wrap it up.
Adamac, Harley Davidson's. I mean, there. I think there's more than two.
Locations.
DMAR. Adamac. They got Adamac in Jacksonville, one in Orange Park. They got one in St. George's, a retail store. They got Adamac. That's Jacksonville again. 72 miles to Jacksonville. You said 90. 72.
Must be on this side of Jacksonville then.
Must be. Here's a little picture.
All right.
You can hit the thing and say, give me direction. That's from here. We're even closer. That way, aren't we? Are we farther?
No, we're further away. So probably by the time we go back to where we're at, it'll be 90 miles.
No, I think it'll be 20 miles.
Anyway.
So, right up here, right off Atlantic Beach. Yeah, we got to turn off that road. I remember that. Atlantic Beach. You got to get in that right lane because it looks like you're going to go there and you got to turn the next road. Very tricky. Ride your motorcycle because it's very hard to get parking there.
Michael Campbell said he'd meet us there and Rapping said he'd meet us up there.
All right. We'll probably ride the bike. That's the plan. And we'll see how
Take
it goes.
Rain too. That way it won't rain.
So with that, we're going to leave you right here at the world famous Teddy Morse
Daytona Harley Davidson.
Pretty neat. They got all the brand new signs are up. They took the banners down. We didn't announce that the other day. They did all that. They did that when we were here Friday. They put all the new signs up.
Shelley.
Yep. So on the video, you get to see the new sign because she kind of chopped her head off because she wanted to see the new sign to be in it.
Well, she said, don't get all the stuff in the back because they had fences around it because they just got done putting the sign up. But she says, don't get all that stuff. So I don't know. I thought that too, but it's like, well, I don't know what to do.
We're going to put some bikes on top of her too. So it's not on top of her.
Run her over. All right. Who said I don't have Facebook up anymore?
So that was Facebook.
Is it? No. Somebody said good night. Whoever that was. Good night on Facebook. Palmodo says, cheers. Choose.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Drinking a Coke.
You'll be burping all night. So thanks for hanging out with us. We appreciate all you guys. Love all you guys. If you're heading down this way, be careful. Keep your eyes out for everything. We're going to leave now. We're wrapping it up.
Is it 6 o'clock?
Okay. Pretty darn close. Yep, it's 6 o'clock.
Are they waiting on us? They're waiting for us to close the store.
The Roadkill Run will come out there. See you guys all later. Take care and be careful. Be safe.